without 50. Like to go out smelling fresh and looking spiffy. Don't like clean money, I want my wrist to be filthy. Plus with that retirement fund, I can't tell till I'm 60. So what am I supposed to do? Rolling through, steady patting them pockets till I'm stacking hole in two. Ching, ching, bling, bling, catching cash and lump. It's a four row, get a jacket, I'm selling them out my trunk. Whenever, whatever, it takes a shake down a dollar. Muzzle in that direction, wait a minute.
Ye of little faith. All you people saying I'm late. I'm not late. I was early. I was early. But it didn't. The fucking streamy thing did not work. Go. Just my fucking luck. Alright. I had to do things the old fashioned way, but it is now working. So, the reason why I picked this, by the way, is my well-deserved, my well-earned monetization for YouTube has finally been enabled. Let me just pull up my emails and read this shit. I got out of bed when I realized this because it came in like just yesterday, and boy oh boy was I excited. Let's see, where the fuck is this thing? Let's see, YouTube. Can I find this email in real time, or is it going to take fucking forever? Oh, it's going to take fucking forever. It basically just said, congratulations, you've been approved. You're now a YouTube partner, which means that I have super chats. I have super chats, everybody. Isn't that fantastic? Now look, they're coming in. That's 20 NOK. Is that Norwegian dollars? 148 gang rip super chats. Oh geez. Okay, so my policy with the super chats, before I get into it, I don't want to lay this out. I want to give people time to roll in so we can watch this together. But let me say right now, my policy with the super chats are going to be, I will definitely see them all as they come in. However, I won't read them necessarily, not automatically. And I won't dedicate like a time slot at the end to reading everyone because I think that's fucking boring. So I will 100% see your super chats almost as soon as they come in. But I will only read them if they're funny or interesting, if people will find them interesting. I'm going to keep my super chats enabled for about 30 minutes because that's when YouTube's going to shit all over me. But for the time being, I feel my proboscis growing in size as my fiendish shekel magic becomes more potent. So before we dig into Amber Lynn, oh geez, that sounded sexual. This isn't going well. I want to show people some other crazy shit that's been happening that I think you'll enjoy. I have some bonus content. Okay. I might do a stream on fucking on this guy just in and of himself. He's such a fascinating train wreck. His docs is actually I mentioned that Jim Metacrew was doxed by somebody called Zedkist on the forum, and I don't even think Jim's docs was really his favorite. The one he put the most work into. The Discord link expired. I'll pull one. But the person he, I think, took the most pride in doxing was this guy called Jake Alley. And Jake Alley is a very interesting person that you might have heard of before. And I'll just show you what he looks like and what he's been saying about my little Kiwi Farms. So that's Jake Alley, a.k.a. Secret Gamer Girl. 100%. If you're involved in Gamergate in any way, you've seen Secret Gamer Girl. And that's what he looks like. He has a fucking luxurious beard. I don't know why you'd want to become a woman when he has those beard genetics. But, you know, whatever. In light of that last thread, and everything he posts on Twitter is 100 tweets long and fucking should be on Medium or something and not on Twitter. But in light of that last thread, to clarify my statement from this morning about the importance of us all coming together to do something about Kiwi Farms and similar sites, don't attempt to contact their web hosts and make a reasonable argument. Do pester your elected representatives to pass stronger laws against the sort of coordinated mass stalking and willful endangerment. Take what steps you can to starve them of revenue streams needed to keep their sites online. This has been going pretty well so far. Super chats. Make it clear as loudly and forcefully as you can how strongly you are opposed to that sort of thing, in particular by shunning them and shaming anyone who you encounter posting links to that site or content from it. No exceptions. Generally spread awareness of said site being maintained by a bunch of violently transphobic fascists. Oh, geez, I don't even have the song ready. I have to load this in real quick. Ah, there we go. I have to keep this going. Because I'm a violently transphobic back. Oh, jeez. Make it quieter so you can hear me better. Transphobic who completely dedicate their lives to making up vicious rumors about trans people and attempting to make them look more credible by archiving every single file they obtain when doing a search on a target's name. Be mindful of legalities if you take direct action to bring the site offline. Expose and take action against staff maintaining the site or its most prolific posters. Anything I failed to list. So if you're a user of the Kiwi Farms, be aware, Jake Alley is fucking after you. Santa Claus has been checking his list. He's been checking it twice. He knows who's been naughty or nice. And all y'all niggas on the Kiwi Farms are on the naughty list. And of course, before we go ahead and look at Virgo, let me play one more clip from our favorite fan. Your stream.me trader shekels over principles. I would like to stream on stream.me, but as I mentioned, the thing was not working. My restreamer. Yeah, I'm sorry. Everybody's mad about stream.me. I will definitely fix that for next time. But my stream has to have at least one complete malfunction a day, or it's not a Josh stream. It's just some bullshit. Okay, let's go ahead and take a listen to this. This is 3 minutes long, and it's comedic perfection.
You're harassing me again, and I'm a married woman. That's not my last name. Okay? And you can't find that documentation. I made it so you will not be able to find this documentation anywhere due to stalking. I changed my name legally, and they waived the ability for you to find out who I am due to incessant stalking. You don't have my name. You don't even have a legal name anymore. So you're a delusion. I already saw what you look like, Junior, with a baseball cap, redneck, with a southern accent. I already
Get
saw
ready.
What you
she
look like.
Progressively loses her shit over time.
With a southern accent, with the gas chambers. I already saw what you look like. Can't show your face, Junior? You can't show your face because you're genetically screwed up. You don't have any power, mister. I have power because I showed my freaking face online, mister. You are, again, going to be thrown off the internet wasting your time for copying somebody else's videos, mister. You're going to be thrown off the internet, you piece of garbage scumbag. You tattooed-covered Yahoo with a southern accent. Baseball caps. Rednecks. Not all people with tattoos are horrible people. I'm saying that's what you are. You are a person with body modification. You're not even real. This makeup here, you made my face look terrible. I don't even wear makeup.
Fucking real cyberbully.
I'm not a phony. You are a phony, loser. You are a talentless person who can't show your freaking face online for a reason, and you haven't won. You don't have my name, and you don't have any information on me. I am an artist. You understand what I am, mister? This is my name. I can name myself anything I want, and I did legally, okay? You don't have a name anymore, mister. God. You don't have a name, you ugly redneck. Covered in tattoos. That's what you are, and that's what these people are, and that's why they're hiding their face. Because they're unsophisticated rednecks, and that's what they look like. And he's laughing. Ha ha ha! Well, no.
The pause it, and I completely killed it. I wanted to pause it where she was laughing. That was the best part, though. We got to the best part, so we can unceremoniously sunset that clip. I don't think she's holding up well. Her thing right now is she loves to bitch about class. She keeps saying that I'm a redneck because I'm from Pensacola, and I'm not from Pensacola. I wasn't born in Florida, but... she keeps calling me a redneck. She denies wholeheartedly that I've lived in Australia, that I've lived in the Philippines, that I've lived anywhere except for Pensacola, which wasn't even where I'm from. But now she's so angry about other people from specifically outside of New York City. She doesn't like people from San Francisco. She doesn't like people from Florida. She doesn't like people from Mobile, Alabama. She goes on and on about how everybody who didn't study at an Ivy League fucking college in New York City or whatever is just scum who has no right to criticize her fucking music and shit. And she's just delightfully insane. And she's been progressively becoming more and more angry as time goes on. And I just love it. Again, YouTube censors. I'm not making fun of people. The things I do out of a genuine, unironic love for people who are different from me, okay? It's just what it is. Okay. And speaking of people who are different from me, I guess that's the segue. I've got my notebook. It wasn't this. I did not do as good a job with the unfortunately with the Couch Crack stream because I didn't start with my notebook. And I know by now that the notebook is the key to all of this. And I have to write down things if I'm going to do a proper stream. And I've tried to archive and organize all this information as much as possible. So with that in mind, who the fuck is Amberlynn Reed, and why do people talk about her? This is Amberlynn Reed, and she's very much a girl cow. I'm going to go ahead and play a clip from her. I'm going to play an entire 7-minute long clip of Amberlynn Reed explaining who Amberlynn Reed is to give her a fair shake. Cause again, this is not a cyberbully stream. I'm appreciating different people. And Amberlynn put out a video saying, "Hi, I'm Amberlynn," some time ago, like in August of this year. And I think it does a pretty good job of explaining exactly who she is, at least from her perspective. And then there are other perspectives and other things worth making fun of. But before we get into that and just play 7 minutes of her talking, I might interrupt it every so often to put in my own comments. I want to do a big thank you to fat people everywhere. I want to give a big thank you to people in the forum. I asked for help, and this is one of the posts. This is basically, they wrote my stream for me. So I'm just going to do a big thank you to Hot Cheeto Puffs, who essentially built this stream for me by laying out her entire life. The Amberlynn forum in and of itself is kind of a strange anomaly on the site, and that's worth talking about. There's a specific board on the Kiwi Farms just called the Beauty Parlor. And the Beauty Parlor is a place for locales that women will find interesting. And not just locales, but other topics like there's huge communities built around fashion and cosplay that women have not only a very big interest in, but a different take on. Like, we'll look at cosplay as men, and we'll make fun of it for certain reasons. But women have a very specific and very vicious approval process, an appraisal process for everything women-related. Yes, like Lolita. Lolita is one of the big ones that that people will be absolutely fucking insane over. And there are, like, genuine crazy people in the community, and people who do, like, there's a girl called Orange Crush, who looks like Elmo, and she does, like, titty streams, and she looks like a 12-year-old boy, really, but she does titty streams, and she's into Lolita, and she's basically just somebody who jerks off pedophiles in a legal sense. At least that's what the people would say. I have no opinions. I'm just a text-to-speech computer program that reads information. So whenever I think of Whenever I think of the Amber Lynn board, it was a containment board. It was, I had never met people on my forum who would attack my moderators, and that it drove me insane. Like, I need staff to make shit work. But if you ever tried to tell an Amber Lynn person, an Amber Lynn follower, don't do this because it makes the site look shitty, they would directly attack the moderators and call them like skanks and shit. They were fucking crazy. So it's like I had to quarantine them into their own board. And it was the only board where I allowed users to dox each other, basically. And it worked. After a while, all the problems stopped. All the bad users who were fucking insane dipshit asshole motherfuckers left of their own accord. And now it's one of the better boards on the site. But I still consider it a quarantine zone. So whenever I click on it, I get this feeling. Let me just pop that clip in.
Biohazard warning.
This is a real clip of entering the Amber Lynn board.
Transmissions jammed. Proximity coverage only. Backup activated. System rebooted. Warning. Entering Noctone.
The users are they're good now. I like them now, but when it first started, it's just like, oh God, can I even do this? But over time, you learn to appreciate it for what it is. And fat people are a source of joy. We can all understand, even though Amber Lynn's not a really deep character, it's easy to understand what the joy of you know, mocking her is. And fat people have brought us one of the best sequences of any motion picture of all time. Let's take a look at that right now.
Ask it, please.
Size.
I don't know yet. Still think about it. I watch my figure. Butchie, you got a 10-piece ready. Thank you
for the shit.
Get her ass. Get that big bitch.
She had bits of chicken and shit stuck to her fucking face at the end. It's the. Oh, it's one of the best. And somebody's complaining. It's been 20 minutes and I haven't said shit. Well, motherfucker. There is a process to this, a warm-up to make sure everybody gets in when we start. And of course, we're going to take a second to pray to our patron saint, Yunnan Nalzaradan, who is the patron saint of bodily fitness, self-awareness, and cutting through fat people's bullshit. And we want to thank him for his duty, for his sacrifice. And with that, I think I want to go ahead and let's do this, because I think most of you, especially people who are watching this from the Ralph Retort community, will recognize Amber Lynn, and they don't know where from. let me show you how internet famous Amber Lynn is.
Special news segment. Special, special, special news segment. Special. Good evening, I'm Poppy Harlow, here for your special news segment. Any YouTuber mentioned in this video is just for context. I am not dragging these people. It's just for context. Full disclaimer, guys. Just context. No, for real, it is just context. I think if this story goes mainstream, which it very likely will, it will have a negative impact on YouTubers. What am I talking about? Well, of course, BetterHelp. You've already heard about it from your favorite YouTuber.
BetterHelp.
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 View BetterHelp.
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 There is a list of over 100 YouTubers who have promoted this website. It's been all over Reddit, my own subreddit. I always see these ads. Try online therapy. Try online therapy and you too can grow a magnificent beard just like this guy. Well, what is BetterHelp? Well, it's been marketed as cheap,
affordable,
and private.
Skip ahead to what I
want to
show specifically. Cut this out, go to live audio. And I think this is right about where he mentions it.
Because they don't take accountability for any of their counselors, which then leads to a lot of people having bad experiences. They say themselves that they don't diagnose. The platform is not intended for diagnosis. But then you have really questionable videos of YouTubers saying,
I suffer with binge eating, which I do want to talk to you guys about because I was officially diagnosed with binge eating disorder by my therapist. Mm-hmm.
I was officially diagnosed by their therapist. Okay, who diagnosed you?
If you guys have ever heard of BetterHelp.com.
Oh, really? So you were officially diagnosed by a therapist. Therapists should not diagnose you, by the way. And BetterHelp themselves say that, but still, apparently, it happens.
I never actually...
So just to make it obvious what has happened, Amber Lynn has ended up as a headless fat person's picture by PewDiePie. And Amber Lynn, of course, did a response to this, but... Essentially, what happened is Amber Lynn told a lie so big and so timely regarding something that just blew up in a big drama way that it caused major reputational damage to a massive $100 million company wrought by PewDiePie. And that's a kind of a reoccurring theme, is that she lies a lot. And I do, oh, I forgot to use this clip. Somebody put this together for me, and I forgot to use it. After, I was going to pause it after you see the pixelated mosaic faces of Amber Lynn, but I'll just play it for the fun of it.
Who's that Pokemon? It's...
Hey, guys.
But yeah, she did that. And now I just want to go ahead and play that an introduction video where she basically just says what she wants. And let me go ahead and set that up. Sorry, I've been clipping shit for 8 fucking hours and it was not enough to get everything I want out of this. It's just fucking crazy. All right, here we go.
Hi, I'm Amber Lynn Reed. I am 27 years old and I am 529 pounds. I'm sure you have seen the comments and you've seen the videos, you've seen the live streams and the forums where people create scenarios, rumors, and situations to manipulate other people's opinions of me. I'm not a liar. I'm not a deceiver, and I don't manipulate
really,
people.
I don't
and
have I much to interrupt with, because she does a good job
I've
of explaining her life history. And
several,
then I want to play other clips on top of that.
To prove myself. I'm the girl who buys tons of jewelry to somehow hide behind a super morbidly obese body. I buy tons of journals to write a story I feel like I'm never going to complete. I'm moody. I'm a mess. I'm restless. I'm depressed. I'm the girl who hasn't left her bedroom in 5 days. Of course, I leave to go to the bathroom or to get something to eat. I haven't brushed my hair in about a week. I feel defeated, lonely. I do YouTube for a living. This is how I pay my bills. This is how
she makes all of her money off of live streaming.
I have a roof over my head, a pillow to lay on at night. I come from a very, very toxic and unhealthy family. When I was 9, I was taken from class by a cop who took me and my brothers to a children's shelter. From then on, I became a ward of the state, and I was in foster care until the age of 18. My parents were drug addicts. They neglected me. I lived in a trailer that was falling apart with mold and holes.
This is also true.
I saw my dad hit my mom more times than I can even count. In school, I was known as Fat Amber. On YouTube, I'm known as the most hated YouTuber. I don't cry for views. I don't eat for views. I live my life, although a dull one, and I just want to share it with everyone out there. I'm not a narcissist. I don't use or mooch the people around me.
He's from fucking Pensacola, constantly. By the way.
Amberlynn, you're a liar. All you ever do is lie, lie, lie. What happens when my reality is different than yours, and really you're just going off of biased opinions? I love to dance and I love to sing. I have 3 fur babies that I love dearly. 2 cats and a dog. My cats are Wasabi and Rarity Gray, and my dog is Twinkie Star. Without them, I feel like I would be absolutely lost. I was never that great in school until I decided to go to college for criminal justice, and I fought so hard for straight A's, and I actually got them. When you put your mind to something and you really try at something, you can succeed. When I see a homeless person, I give them money, even if they're gonna go buy alcohol. Both of my parents and my brother have been homeless before, so I have seen the true meaning of living a homeless life. I am a lesbian. I have a girlfriend that I love.
By the way, the people saying I should hit her up, I can't. She's gay. I'm sorry, guys. Sorry to disappoint.
I don't know what I want out of my life, and I feel like my thoughts are hard to convey. Everything within my mind is just jumbled and confused. Right now, I'm struggling. I'm caught in a situation where I don't know if it's my antidepressant making me worse, or if my depression is so bad that Lexapro just doesn't work for me. I haven't been able to leave this hazed mind for almost a week now. If I could be anywhere right now, I'd probably lay in a field of sunflowers and just look up at the sky and ask why. Why me? I constantly wonder, why was I chosen to go through the things I went through? To become 529 pounds, to have depression, and to have a whole huge online community hate me for something that isn't true. I understand when there's 2 stories, you want to choose one. And it sucks because one person is telling the truth, and yet she's perceived
as a liar. Gonna straighten her out. Fuck off.
I am extremely empathetic. If I'm hanging with someone and they're in a bad mood, I automatically take on their emotions. And I become kind of in a bad mood. If I see someone crying, if they're a stranger, I follow suit and I feel their pain. To have that empathetic personality, it's bittersweet. Not only do I take on the role of feeling everyone else's emotions, but I also have to deal with mine. If I was given a second chance and a clean slate, I feel like I would do everything differently. When I lay down at night with my head on the pillow, I wonder if I'll wake up and realize that everything was just a dream. The hate comments, the threats, being told I'm unwanted and hated. It's a nightmare that I live in my reality. More than anything, I want people to see me for the real person that I am. But rumors are like the plague, and I feel like it'll never stop. It'll just be a vicious cycle until the day that I die. I used to steal when I was younger. When I was a teenager, I rebelled against everyone and anything that I can get my hands on. I would steal shoes from stores, makeup from stores. I didn't have anything. I didn't have anyone. I felt like nobody cared about me. So I started stealing. I was drinking and smoking all the time. My last year of high school, I finally got persuaded into doing better and really focusing on what mattered the most. My point is, I've made mistakes. I really have. And one thing I've learned from my mistakes is that when I admit to them, it doesn't make my mistakes right, but it gives me a chance to forgive myself. God, I love fashion so much, and I love makeup. I'm not in the body to where I can actually wear something or have my makeup be done and actually consider it beautiful. Have you ever felt like a monster? People stare at me like I'm like a creature from the ocean, and then I put myself out there on YouTube expecting some positive feedback or something. I was watching a YouTube video
first once, mistake,
and they said, don't listen to your bad commenters. Don't let them define you, but also don't let the good ones define you either. That really stuck to me. I always read a good comment and think that they're lying because I get so much negativity all the time. It's hard to believe anyone would like me. I don't know what my future videos look like or what my future looks like in general. I have a therapist I'm talking to. I'm hoping that the therapist is a fit for me because I don't want to be wasting my time with someone who just doesn't get me. I appreciate my subscribers, my views. I appreciate that I can make a living off of doing something that I truly enjoy. But right now, I'm currently not myself. Struggling with this dark fog has been painful. And then I go online and see horrible things being said about
server chat. Just endure a little bit more.
Process even worse. I don't know what kind of videos I'm going to be filming. I don't even know how I will be feeling 2 days from now. But I'm not going to give up. I'm going to keep pushing forward. And I'll try my hardest not to let anyone down. I just want to end with, you never know what someone is struggling with. Just because someone gets up every day and goes to work or takes their kids to school does not mean they're not suffering. Don't believe everything that you read online. If you didn't hear it from me, then it's probably not true. And some advice that I'm giving you that I'm also giving myself, stop and smell the roses.
Oh, geez. It's a lot to digest. Again, I apologize for playing that in its entirety. It is 7 minutes long. But I feel it's necessary. The entire thing is necessary. She does a really good job of basically outlining her entire life. And I was going to go over most of that, what she said. But I felt it would be more fair. And again, I'm not a cyberbully. I'm here for the sake of fairness. I'm like Keemstar. I just report the news. But it's more fair to just let her say what she wants. It was only 7 minutes. And I think it's pretty concise. One of the things worth mentioning, worth reiterating, is that yes, she does make all of her money from live streaming off of YouTube and off of YouNow. YouNow is similar, it's kind of like a trashier female version of YouTube, and it's had live super chats for like a long time. They have their own thing with their own currency and shit. But she makes a lot of money off of that too. She does have a small circle of diehard fanatics who have been following her for years. And somebody mentioned DSP. I would say DSP is a pretty apt comparison. Because Amber Lynn is somebody who got into streaming hoping for a kind of relaxing, easy way to make money by being an entertainer. And what they ended up with was a very stressful kind of shark circle that constantly picks at them. And yes, they make money to make the ends meet, but at the same time, they're not putting out the kind of entertainment that they would want to. And really, the only difference between Amber Lynn and just some other fat white trash from Pensacola, of which there is a lot, is that Amber Lynn broadcasts themselves every day. And if they didn't, they would be completely forgotten. But they have chosen to make their life entirely public on the internet. And for that, we thank them. Okay, so she was born with meth heads, that's true. I feel like I feel like John Oliver, where after she says something, I have to pause and go, yes, that's true, that happened. I have to make sure everybody knows what to think as we proceed. She lived with a crazy aunt named Tammy, who we will get into, at her smallest when she was Fat Amber. She was 250 pounds, so that was even during elementary school and during high school. And when you talk about Amber Lynn, you kind of have to approach her life as being in sagas, like with Christian. And the sagas are broken up based on what girlfriend she's with at the time, and that'll make more sense as we pull into really the first girlfriend that I want to show people, and probably the most significant. There's four. Casey, Crystal, Destiny, and Becky. Becky and Casey are the most noteworthy. And it'll be obvious why Casey is the most noteworthy. I apologize to the YouTube overlords who are going to penalize me when I start talking about Casey, because Casey is now female to male. And I don't know what the fuck their name is now. Amberlynn did something to Casey that made them want to become a man. And unfortunately, I don't have Casey's new name to go by. Let's start watching some clips. Let's start watching some clips from what Casey has to say. And I apologize for the audio quality. This is from an archive that one of Amberlynn's hate followers archived a long time ago. And it's literally just her recording her iPhone. And you can hear her laughing and snickering in the background. So if you hear that, if you hear a girly snicker in the background, I promise you it's not me.
If I could say one thing to her,
ooh,
just live an honest life. Nothing comes out of lies and deception. Really, it doesn't. Nothing comes out of lies and deception. Just live an honest life. More people.
She's in the chat trying to get on, and that's what's happening right now.
Did someone ask to guest her? I'm not making her a guest on here. I'm not gonna guest her. Sorry. No.
Dios mío, la criatura. My puppy.
I'm not gonna talk to her on here. I'm not guesting her. I'm not letting her guess. You guys don't have to keep posting it. It's okay. She is blocked. She is blocked on everything. The last thing I ever got from her. Where's my phone? Ah, here it is. And I'll pull it up right now and I'll show you guys. Last thing I ever got from her was two things. One was, I believe, almost a year ago, was on my YouTube messaging thing. I didn't even know you can message on YouTube. I really didn't. She wanted to talk. I deleted it. I didn't acknowledge it because there was nothing to talk about. And then one of the other things I got from her, and I'll show you. Let me just get to it.
It's a he, chat. I have to correct you. It's a he. Use the proper pronouns. Check your privilege.
It was September 16th, 2016. I don't know if you guys can see that. That was the last thing I ever got from her before I blocked her.
People are now contacting Destiny's family. People are calling the cops and calling PETA to get my animals taken from me.
She can watch all
I feel
she wants
hopeless.
I guess.
Please delete the video. What video could she be talking about? Well, that's kind of the interesting point. Seems there's a little bit of a drama, and based on the giggling that you heard in that video, as that girl recorded her screen, it's some fucking juicy ass drama. Or as they say in the girl locale websites, it's some pretty good tea. It's some piping hot fucking tea for everybody. Let's continue, because I don't know at what point chat will realize what happened between them.
You have the potential to do great.
This is Casey addressing
Amberlynn. I know it because I've seen it. You going to school for criminal justice like you were? You had all the potential. You had a good heart to help people.
Officer Amberlynn.
It's never too late to change in life. Be honest. Be honest with your fans, your subscribers. Be truthful. Don't lie. Don't hide yourself behind lies, because that all, it leads to chaos, and it leads to this, all this. And yes, you may lose subscribers, and you may lose friends, and you may lose supporters if you, like, come clean with certain things, and you come clean with stuff you've lied about, because as I'm reading right here, people have caught you in lies.
A lot.
But if you can just rebuild on the truth, you will have much more in truth than in lies. And as I've said before, and I'll even address all of you guys too. Life is hard. Life is hard. It's nothing like they tell you. Or
jilted lovers for sure, but
it's not.
But what was so jilted about this, guys? Can anybody take a guess? If I see it, I'll call it out as being true.
Job, have your place, party. Or, well, I don't party, but, you know, like, have your friends over, play video games, do whatever you want. No, it's not the case. I learned real quick. But, I'm gonna tell Amber, I'm gonna tell all you guys this. This is how I view all this. When life is hard.
Life is strange.
Growing up, people grow up either with a silver spoon in their mouth, a gold, a diamond, a bronze, a wooden, I don't know. People grow up in different ways. People grow up through different circumstances, some good, some bad, some ugly, some horrible. But the thing about growing.
All right, Nameless is the first one to call it out in chat. Amber Lynn Reed accused her ex-girlfriend Casey of raping her. Which is a pretty fucking big accusation. Now, if you don't know this, and I don't want to get on some kind of far-right political rant, but lesbians have an incredibly high, disproportionate amount of domestic abuse in their relationships. And the rape accusation was false, as I'll talk about. But it's not exclusive. That's not the only accusation being thrown here. So let's continue. I wonder what she has to say about fighting back, perhaps.
Advisor on what I should do, because I don't want to, as I said before, I really don't want to have to be in a courtroom with her. I don't want to be anywhere near her.
Does not want to be in a courtroom with Amber Lynn. I wonder why. I wonder maybe if anybody could corroborate Amber Lynn's story against Casey. Maybe the second girlfriend, Crystal.
Amber keeps saying that Crystal saw firsthand how you treated her. What do you think she's talking about? Oh, I know exactly what she's talking about. It was when we were at the anime convention. And I like anime. I love anime. I'm a nerd. But we were at an anime convention, and I was having an anxiety attack. And me and Amber were still together, and I wanted my girlfriend at the time to comfort me, and Crystal got mad at it. Now, I understand why Crystal got mad about that, because Amber wanted to, you know, spend time with her, and she came down for Amber, blah, blah, blah. But that's what it was. So whatever she told Crystal, she told Crystal.
Okay, and I have, again, as an arbiter of my community and as a partner for YouTube, I have to correct some hate speech that I'm seeing in chat. As we all know, there is literally nothing wrong with lesbians. Can we stop the hate speech, guys? I don't want to have to add moderators, but come on now. Come on now. Now, mention that there might be some alternative accusations being thrown around here. Let's see what that can mean.
I wouldn't necessarily say thrown, but I like fell back on the bed and she just continued to hit. Like, God, I was just like trying to at least block my face, but just hit and slap and slap, and then she like slammed the door and took off walking to the store. That was the worst. That was the scariest and worst night ever. Ever. Just the constant.
Look at what she's typing. What a bitch.
And that was scary. That. And I guess another thing that broke my heart was when she told me that she hurts the people she loves the most. You don't hurt the people you love the most. You protect the people you love the most.
You know, everything I've seen from Casey has been, you know, really nice. She comes across as really soft-spoken and really nice in this video. I would pay money to see Amber Lynn in a fist fight. I would pay money that I don't have. I would take out a loan at the bank to get that fucking footage. Just saying. Nothing personal, kid. Ooh, I want to save that clip for last. That's a good one. The potential reason why it's so easy to divide her story up into sagas, depending on the girlfriend, is that Amber Lynn tends to take on the personality of the person she's with. And, for instance, with Becky, people say that she's very aggressive and kind of dykey with Becky. And I like Becky, too. Everything I've seen of Becky. Becky is the most likable of all the girlfriends. But here's a clip of Casey talking about how Amber Lynn takes on certain traits of people.
Amber told you she had a disability. She told me that she had anxiety after I was diagnosed. So
That clip went by really fast. So just to reiterate, what happened is she said that after Casey was diagnosed with anxiety, Amber Lynn began to say that she was diagnosed with anxiety too. And as we've seen with the PewDiePie clip, Amberlynn has no reservations about lying about a diagnosis. Her saying that she was formally diagnosed with an eating disorder through BetterHelp is indicative of one of two things. Either one, the therapist on BetterHelp diagnosed her illegally, or she lied about what the therapist said and receiving a diagnosis from that therapist. So she clearly has no reservations about not being entirely truthful about certain provable medical conditions that she might have. Actually, I want to save this one for last. Let's go with this clip next.
Would you ever consider taking her back if she asked? No. 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 Has lying always been an issue with Amber? Yeah.
The question was, has lying always been an issue with Amberlynn? And she says yes. Amberlynn catches, again, one of the things she mentions in that introductory video that I played is that she catches a bad rep due to certain internet forums about being a liar or a manipulator. And part of that will make sense in a little bit. It's the last clip I want to play. This one is potentially damaging, more so to how you might perceive Amberlynn, but let's go ahead and play it.
You and Amber when she moved in with you.
To reiterate the question, how old were you when you moved in with Amberlynn?
You and Amber when she moved in with you. Your mom, I was 16 and she was 18.
That's it. Amberlynn moved in with Casey and her parents. When Amberlynn was 18 and Casey was 16. Not a huge age difference, but, you know, I'm not on her Christmas list right now, so I might as well fling whatever shit I can. I want to say Casey is not... Amberlynn did... Oh, fuck, I couldn't find this. I desperately searched for this, guys, I promise. It's just that Amberlynn's a locale that's dominated by women, and women don't know how to archive shit. If you're a woman, please read our guide on how to archive shit, because there are better ways to do it than with recording your monitor. And Amberlynn did a slam poem about Casey and about the rape. And I could not find the fucking poem. It's killing me. I wish I could find it, but I don't have it. Amberlynn did walk back the rape accusation. She, quote, used the wrong word, but she did initially accuse Casey of rape. And one final quote from this two-hour live stream that I've clipped apart into several minutes. That's right, random lady. Okay, I didn't realize I had clipped that much. I almost forgot about the ankles. Let me write that down so I don't forget it. So the less funny thing that she mentions is that Amberlynn... Wait, what do you mean muted? I'm not fucking muted. Do I have to replay it? I'll just replay it. It's like 30 seconds. Oh, I'm sorry. I had it on the wrong output.
When Amber tried to add your mother and her partner on Facebook years after you broke up, yeah, she's still on my mom's Facebook.
That's weird.
I believe she is. I'm not quite sure. My mom is a good person. She cared. My mom wants to know how she's doing, and it breaks my heart that that she may come across this and see that this is all happening again. I'm not talking about our ankles. I'm not talking about our ankles.
Okay. You guys heard it that time. Geez, women can't archive. I had it on the wrong output. Hey, I was doing fine up until then. Give me a fucking break. It's hard to juggle all this shit. I don't have an editor. I don't have a producer. I'm doing it live, motherfucker. But the creepy thing about that clip is that Amberlynn and Casey's mother were friends on Facebook, and they still talked years after they broke up. And apparently Casey's mom did not know about the accusations or the abuse or anything that had happened after or that caused them to break up. So the implication with that is if Casey were to cause problems, Amberlynn could slip some fucking bombs into her mother's ear and make home life very fucking uncomfortable. And I'm talking about manipulation. That's a pretty fucking big card to have on somebody to say, I can tell your mom that you rape me and make your life living fucking hell if you do anything to piss me off. That would piss me off. That would scare me. I don't know if anything came of that, but the threat was out there. That communication being open after these accusations had come out, I can't imagine it being anything else besides a threat. So, somebody sent me this video. I have no idea what the fuck it is. It could be horrible, horrible fetish pornography, but we'll check it out. I think C3P something. They had the avatar of Bender. I think they're a user on the forum. So thank you if this is what I think it is.
Speaking Up by Amberlynn Reed.
Oh, Jesus.
Let's see. Who does everyone believe? Let's start gambling our life, rolling dice like knives on a platter. Who will survive? Will it be the false nightmare you spit or the reality I have tied? Tied to a place of sadness, and now revealed an altar into madness. Why are you going to break the tide and just leave it there? Break the ice and throw the stone and not think twice? Why are you going to play your sins and call me twice? Twice the lies, twice the price, twice the vulgar manipulated web. Spider to friend, friend to spider, enemy grudge and love lost. Using my name to put yours on lights? What happened to all the fights, all the times they turned into goodbyes? No, I am not perfect in any way. No inside the lines, no glitter outside, no gracefully worded rhymes. No playing perfect like you've begun a show that keeps haunting me. The haunt is the demon I'm trying to escape.
I like how she puts her heart into it.
Insane. Escape the thoughts and the online taunts.
The online taunts.
Just admit you were wrong and play a different song. Admit the guilt you've sown like a misguided basket case of poison sentences.
Ham poetry, fuck you.
The chapter has torn pages, scribbled words of false advertisement. I'm my own narrator, yet you stole the pen to deny, to lie, to pry into life that was fine. Here are the facts. You lied about your name right off the bat, but still called me insane. You put a ring on my finger, promised me forever, yet you kissed her. You kicked and screamed till it was making hate. Forget making love.
Was she kicking and screaming because you were beating her?
Rain and petals eavesdrop. I used the wrong word. Rain and petals eavesdrop. I used the wrong word. Rain and petals eavesdrop. I used the wrong word. My mental hygiene has been rotten and
stuck. I like how every time she said every time she said that line, she repeated it three times. She pouted like every fucking time, and that was annoying me so much I had to pause the video to give myself reprieve from this fucking garbage.
Abuse in the picture frame, put on a smile. What I see behind the fake glass reflecting, noise destroying, shimmer clatter frame breaks. I don't understand your left hand connected to your heart, but it's so cold enough to ruin me. Listen, my heart doesn't beat for you. I don't bleed for you. I don't need you. Social media needs this, a drama story, something to decipher, something to dissect, to entertain, to observe, to twist and to melt over. It's not fair for strangers to pick a side to bash and a side to hate, a side to love and a side to hash out propaganda. Bashing, lashing, tasteless hashing. I want to be understood. To cowardly clarify, I'm going to say bad choices don't make you a bad person. Almost 7 years have glided to 1,555 days, 61,320 hours. I've cried, I've laughed, I've loved, I've lost, I've tapped,
yeah, I hate this too, Chad.
One succeeded, failed. I've groaned, I've learned, I've moved on, healing along the way. The moon moved from the sun and roses blossomed.
It sounds like she's laughing at how bad her own poetry is.
I placed a hand on my blood-red heart, hoping one day it'll all be gone. Everything written with the unhealthy circumstances, all the tears that stained my pillowcases, the cruel, hateful comments I received in anger, the wrong assumptions everyone made, the thought of wishing myself off this jaded earth, and the lies you placed in my reality. Specked and spiked.
God, how long does it go on? It's almost over.
Sound, tearing apart at the seams, I covered all the screams. Screams so silent, yet so loud, profound, profoundly intense in ending this final dance. Knowing what you did and saying you didn't. Such a lovely story.
Damn, girlfriend, you really got her with that shit. Somebody paid money for me to read this. I guess I have to. Imagine getting a rim job from this brat hog. She'd suck your weak little sphincter out like a noodle, Josh boy. Thanks, asshole. We're going to need some good poetry to wash that down with. So let's take a break.
I am the werewolf. Help. Werewolf in London.
Werewolf in Paris.
Werewolf is fun.
Werewolf is cute. Werewolf is gothic.
I turned myself into a werewolf.
Fight two demons. Werewolf is boys. Naked.
Oh, God.
Favored.
I like to make werewolf movies.
I fight vampires.
Werewolves like to howl.
I wonder what her disability is.
They meet in the jungle of dirt.
Every night I turn myself into a werewolf.
See, again, we're not making fun of them. We're just appreciating their differences together as a community of people. Okay. I got the laughs out. So for Crystal and Destiny, moving on from the rape story. Oh, before we move on from the rape story, guys, I have to show you cankles. Because, again, we appreciate the differences of people, etc. That's not her. There we go. There is a 14-page thread on the Kiwi Farms dedicated to Amberlynn's cankles. Let's see what they got in the first post. Sorry, my proxy from Israel is not downloading this fast. Oh, geez, that's a good ankle. Look at that. It's like a donut sitting on top of a foot. Take a look at that cankle. Oh, geez, it's got like a bulge. It's like it's carrying a sack of toys down the chimney. Oh, that doesn't even look like a foot. That's rough. Is this the appropriate time to, let me talk about the next two girlfriends, because I don't have any video content for them, so it'll be relatively short. Crystal was the next girlfriend. Crystal was mentioned vaguely by Casey in that last video. Crystal's parents gave Amberlynn $1,200 a month, and Amberlynn was able to collect food stamps while living with them, which kind of sets up Amberlynn being a mooch, a little bit of a mooch. Somebody asks, is this legal? Yeah, they're just fucking cankles. Of course it's legal. So Casey, or Crystal, was mooched off of for quite some time, and the most notable thing about Crystal breaking up... No, I'm sorry. This was Destiny that had that. Yeah, really, with Crystal, she just mooched off of her. I don't know of any drama there. I'm checking chat. If somebody knows some good Crystal drama, let me know, and I'll read it. But basically, Amberlynn just mooched off them until they got bored of them. Destiny was the next. Destiny was mentioned. Destiny was apparently the worst. I saw somebody in chat saying that Destiny was the least tolerable of all the different girlfriends. Destiny apparently worked, or Amberlynn actually worked a couple jobs for short periods of time while with Destiny. Crystal was apparently special needs. So Amberlynn and Crystal, Amberlynn got like a caretaker stipend for apparently sleeping with this chick by their parents. Destiny was a Chad, they're saying. Destiny's the best girlfriend? What? Oh my god, I'm receiving conflicting information about the quality of girlfriend here. Bitches' feet have a beer gut. Yeah, they're pretty nasty. That's why they have a 14-page thread. The most notable thing about Destiny was that Amber Lynn, for the last 3 years, has celebrated Christmas a little bit early. Literally, I think there was a famous video where she, in like the middle of November, so like a date that had already been passed this year, opened all the gifts under the tree with Destiny to keep her around. And that gambit only lasted long enough to get her to stay until Valentine's Day. And she got dumped right before Valentine's Day, which resulted in Amber Lynn getting white girl trashed on wine and live streaming herself in the process. And if you don't know what white girl drunk looks like with a 500-pound woman, this is what it looks like. There is a very important footnote. The video itself is boring. She's just doing this shit in front of a camera. And like it's like 13 minutes of drunk, incoherent rambling and shit. I can play it if people really want me to. But the main thing that I... Is this my desktop? No. This is not my desktop. The most notable thing that Destiny did, at least in my research, is she recorded this clip. And if you're not watching it, if you can't watch it, I feel bad for you. But if you aren't watching the stream, now is the time to look at the stream, because you need to see Amber Lynn's face during this video.
And here we observe.
What?
Amber Lynn in her natural habitat.
What?
Denny's.
Was that a fat joke?
No.
Look at how displeased she is.
Make fat jokes.
Nope.
How's your day been?
Good, how's yours?
Pretty good.
Is that good? Chips and queso.
Mm-hmm.
Was it no more chips?
Just amazing. Did you see how fucking quickly she changed the topic? That fucking ice cold stare that she got after she said that? It reminded me of this clip. Let me go ahead and pull this up because this is important. This is an important parallel to draw. Let's see if I can find it real quick. Doing it on the fly as always. Why is it in Hebrew? What the fuck? I can't read Hebrew, goddammit! Oh, there we go. Perfect. I'm great at this. I'm assuming... Oh, it's on the fucking quickie. I don't know if that's gonna... If that's even gonna load. Goddamn Hebrew Google. If I can't find this, I'm gonna actually be legit fucking sad about it. Let me check the archive. Is this not archive? Fuck you. God damn it. I'm legit gonna fucking be mad. Hold up, this is worth it. I promise you this comparison is worth it. If I can just make it happen. Oh, fuck. I don't even know what the fuck this guy is. I don't want to see his videos. There's a fucking video where Chris is recording Barb. And it's the first time that Chris Chan's recording his mother. And he's trying to make small talk with her. And she's not having it. And at one point, she's just like, eat your food. And that's what that was to me. I get flashbacks to Chris being told to eat his food by his mom after not wanting to have small talk. And Amber Lynn uploaded that video on her own channel. It's like a cute moment between her and Destiny. All right. Why is it in Hebrew? Oh, jeez. I'm found out. Holy Gavalt. How do you think I got monetization, Goy? I know people. This is something that somebody showed me on the Kiwi Farms that I think is worth it. This is from a video of her putting on clothes, and the entire video is fucking boring, but this clip in particular... is great because I don't know. I imagine only like 40% of the people in chat right now are women. And if you're a woman, you probably recognize immediately what's wrong with that dress. It's backwards. Those strings are supposed to be the did your mom never ask you to tighten her dress from the back because you couldn't reach it? That's what those strings are for. They're not a fucking cleavage window. It's a dress you're supposed to tie in the back, but she's using it to show off her titties. And a girl requested that I showcase this because it's funny, and I agree it's funny. What else I got? I have so much. Oh gosh, I've been clipping for like hours and hours. Oh, fucking hell. Okay, we got to talk about Becky. Before I talk about Becky, though, there's some... Oh, where the fuck is it? Oh, jeez. Oh, God. It was something having to do with cankles. Is it gone? Is it gone forever? Ah, fuck. No, okay. No, never mind. I'm exactly where I thought I would be right now. It's good. We're good. We're all good. Everything's fine. Disaster avoided. I just don't have them loaded up in OPS. Okay, this is Becky. Becky is my favorite of all the ones I've seen. Yes, that is a Blink 182 t-shirt. Becky fits perfectly into the t-shirt. It is... This is when I think Becky, this is what I think in my head. This is Becky to me. And Becky is just... Becky comes across harmless to me. I imagine people would disagree. Does she have Down syndrome? Who? I don't think so. I vote Amber Lynn as a priestess of Nurgle. I don't even know who Nurgle is. I'm too young. I'm too young and weird to know what a Nurgle is. how can I possibly introduce this to people? Oh, can I just show this clip? Oh, okay. Now let me show you this clip. Becky has a very notable thing in that in their videos together, she kind of fucked up once. Because again, I did not mention that the reason why she started streaming to begin with is that she was doing a weight loss thing, and when she lived with Casey, I think it was Casey, because the parents controlled the food, she actually lost 85 pounds, and that's when she started streaming. But once she was done with Casey, she gained all that weight back and much more. I think she's twice her size at her lowest when she was with Casey, and they were dieting her correctly. So keep this in mind when you're watching these videos and shit. Keep in mind that this is supposed to be a weight loss blog, and she's constantly promising, I'll do a weight loss update. Then the weight loss update gets delayed, and when she finally does it, what does she say? I've gained another 10 pounds. And I can actually, let me detour. I'm so off the road right now. I have no idea what I'm doing. I'm just going for it. the Kiwi Farms YouTube channel got its start with Amber Lynn Reed. I don't know if you can see this, but I just made it so I could upload this video. And if you haven't seen it, we need to watch it together.
Hey guys. Okay, so now that all this is situated, we can eat.
She's 28, I think. This is to this day the most popular video I've ever done. This is my coup de grace. the best of the Kiwi Farms.
Depression is a scary thing.
My strategy for clipping this, by the way, I took one of her mukbangs or whatever the fuck.
I know a lot of you can look at my videos now and be like, girl, you ain't got a life.
And I cut out everything she said unless it was funny. And it wasn't her, specifically the time between when she puts the fork to the plate, when she puts it to her mouth, and that time is what I've clipped it as. And it's just perfect, because this is a dry plate of pasta. And she even says in the video, I'm a dry girl. And that's disgusting, number one. I don't want to hear about that. Number two, she's eating a serving tray of pasta. Like, just cooked plain pasta. So, with a couple meatballs. We're actually going to watch this. We're going to watch all of this. I want you guys to soak it in that she's just packing the shit in. The actual video is like 18 minutes, but that's only because she's talking so much.
I think my next mukbang is gonna be fruit. I'm gonna think about. Okay.
Okay, that was a good excuse to go to a pee break. Why do people watch this? This is my edit of it. They watch it because it's fantastic, number one. But the actual video, I don't know. Like that, when I played those clips from that girl who was recording her stream, like you could hear her laughing and snickering in the background. And I think a lot of people hate Watch Amberlynn. But what her actual fans get out of watching her, I have no idea. Look at her pack that shit down.
Do you guys like meatballs?
Yes. Eat it. Are you showing us feeder porn? I hope not. Say the line. Say the line.
So yeah. I devoured that. I just feel like if I sat here and chewed super slow and like talked a lot, this video would be like 3 hours long.
Well, because you got so much on your plate, bro. I hate the bully, but oh Jesus. Okay, let's play that Becky clip that I've been delaying playing for some time, because I have to do this right, and I don't have the setup. Unfortunately, I ran out of time. There's so much I was doing and reading, I didn't. I didn't get to clip everything that I wanted. Where are you? Okay, this is it. This is funny. If you can watch this, I'd suggest you watch it. And no, this isn't a comedy edit that's coming up. That's her video. So this is her spending some quality time with Becky, you know, as they do. Somebody said that I was doing a lesbian drama stream. Well, I already did that with Life is Strange, so I have some experience. Let's watch that again. I want you to pay attention to the point of view. I want you to think about where the camera is when you watch this. Where is the camera? Why is the camera? It seems like if she's standing up, she's holding it right at about her gut, right? Wait, hold up. Freeze the video, y'all. We need some CSI shit. Look up at the top of the screen if you can. You might see. Let me see if I can open this in Firefox to display it better. Because if you haven't picked up on what's happening yet, we gotta CSI enhance this shit. That to me, y'all, looks like she's sitting on a scooter and she's recording while seated. Oh, geez. That's embarrassing. Because she is supposed to be on a weight loss kick, right? Well, after this got posted on the Kiwi Farms, and huge shout out to the person who, actually, let me pull it up, because I genuinely want to give props to this person, because they fucking are hysterical. Is this the video? Sunny Days points out, I think she's using a scooter. The POV is so low. And then Rice Cake just replies with that screenshot I posted. And it's one of the funniest fucking things I've ever seen in my entire life. It is pure comedy. And thank you very much, Rice Cake and Sunny Days, for getting that. You guys are top-notch. But after this got pointed out on the Kiwi Farms, as things frequently do get pointed out, Amberlynn was forced to be honest. Let's see what that looks like.
Where is Becky? I booked it out of there like a ninja. Where do we park? Oh, I forgot that we parked so close. So yeah, handicapped Walmart area. Is just right here.
Okay, right there. The Walmart is just right there, and they get into the fucking car.
Can you guys imagine me mowing the
lawn? And this is her just...
And that...
Her admiring some motorized murder scooters.
I was like, what is it?
A lawnmower.
She had explained to me what that was.
You ever seen a lawnmower like that?
I mean, I've seen those kinds over there.
I like the scooter selection.
So...
Okay, get ready for it.
Okay, so I'm just looking at
if you're a regular user or viewer of Amberlynn, you have not seen her in a scooter yet. So this is the first time you're being introduced to the scooter.
It's super cute because it has that like knitting in the back, and they have white and they have black. I got me a shirt. So
that's her audio, not mine.
It is a 3X, but it's, I don't know, it's kind of, hold on. It is a
that choker.
3X, but it's kind of like bigger and stretchy. So I wanted to talk to you guys. This is like rather embarrassing. I don't know where Becky went. She just like booked it. But I have been using a scooter lately, and I just wanted to be honest with you guys.
After she got caught
recently, my like just being bigger, everything is harder for me. It's been harder for me to walk.
Oh fuck! I cut that too early. She goes on to say that she only uses it right now because she has a cough or something. But she is always in the scooter now. All of her videos involve her being in the scooter. And it's like, you know, you're trying to lose weight, you're self-conscious about your body, and you're going to Walmart to get food. Can you at least go to Walmart? And like, you can lean on your cart. You can propel yourself while leaning on your cart. You have no excuse. But no, the chronic laziness to even have the gal to sit in a fucking scooter at Walmart and buy groceries when you have nothing wrong with you kills me. Like, and to hide it, to lie about it until the fucking Kiwi Farms catches you CSI Miami style scooting around in fucking Walmart is just unbelievable to me. I have all these... Oh, MSPEC sent me all these different... clips. I guess I can just go through. Go away. I can just throw them up and go through them. And then I have one final clip that's kind of funny. It's not related to this, but it's funny to me. and then I'll outro it. I've decided I'm not gonna do call-ins anymore because people seem to hate them. I don't know what I can do about that. I apologize if you want to call in. She mentions that she can't jump at all. She's physically incapable of jumping at this point, which I guess isn't really a surprise. What's this? Oh, jeez. Get this away from me. What the fuck? I don't want to see that MSPEC fucker. That's her dancing. This was when she was significantly smaller. She's getting up to 600 pounds now. Keep going. Oh, this is her dancing under current weight. Oh, God, she looks like... This is not a cyberbullying stream. I want to emphasize that, but I can't help but feel... I can't help but be reminded of something of... of something else. Actually, let me throw that back up there so I can make a direct comparison. I think you guys will appreciate this. Load. Load, you fucker. There we go. I'm sorry. Again, I'm not cyberbullying. I love Jesus Christ. And I love Israel. But, I mean, she's got the 6 indents and everything going on. Like, you can't tell that's not a dead ringer. That's just what it is. It's just what it is. I'm sorry. Okay. What's this? Oh, it's more of her dancing. Inspect really likes her dancing. What's this so fucking big? Oh, she really likes Cheetos. That's another reoccurring Amberlin facet. I don't even know. Oh, is she eyeing him? That would make me uncomfortable, to be honest. I think this one just showcases her arms. Where'd it go? Come back to me. Oh, don't break on me now, OBS, you fucking piece of shit. I got all this other shit I want to show people, and you're gonna cuck me. You're gonna cuck me, OBS. Ah, fuck off. Oh, there we go. That one didn't want to load up. Inspex really likes pictures of her dancing. Oh, she mentioned in her intro video she really likes makeup. I like makeup. I need the Rocky montage music in the background. Yeah, bless that OBS from stopping you from receiving this high-quality content. I think not. Was that her going downstairs? Ooh, that looks dangerous. Ooh, that reminded me. I'm glad I went through these because I forgot a video. I forgot a video I 100% know everybody here will want to see. Where is it? Where is it, motherfucker?
This video was kind of just a few random little updates.
Where the fuck is it?
But
there it is.
I have fallen twice, 2 days in a row. Well, it's actually technically 2 nights in a row. I don't fall, you guys. I never, ever, ever fall. It's just not something that happens to me. I wouldn't really consider myself a clumsy person either. So the fact that this has happened twice in a row scares me a little bit, and I kind of just want to talk about the situation. And as you guys know, I am over 500 pounds. So a person who's 500 pounds falling, you know, what does that feel like? What goes through my mind? How does my body feel afterwards? Am I okay? Can I walk? What even happened? So I wear flats every time I leave the house, and something really weird, I don't know if anyone else experiences this, but after I wear flats and I take them off, the bottom of my feet are like baby butt soft. I don't know what it is. They're not sweaty or anything like that. Like, that's weird. But they're like soft, kind of like the softness of a really soft pair of socks or something. And our floor, we don't have any carpet at all. And so we had just gotten home from somewhere, and I was sitting on my bed, which is on the floor. I prefer my bed on the floor. I'm able to get up fine. That's not, you know, the issue here. But I had just taken off my flats, so the bottom of my feet were super soft. I don't understand why this happens. It's so weird. But I had to go to the bathroom. So I was getting up off the bed. And to get up off the bed, I do this little, like, turny bit. And I get up by using, like, the strength in my feet. And my feet slipped from under me, and I landed on my left knee. It terrified me. I couldn't get up or anything. So how I had to get up was I had to crawl onto the bed in this like weird maneuver. And it was pitiful. I was like, are you for real right now? I feel like the second time, which was last night, actually scared me a bit more, because this time I was wearing my flats. I decided, you know what, if I'm gonna start getting up off the bed and my freaking feet are so damn soft that I'm gonna slip on this like flooring, it's kind of like a hardwood floor. You guys have seen it in my videos before,
But if I'm gonna be slipping now, I wanna just have shoes on that have a grip, and my flats do have a grip. This was actually in the middle of the night. I had to get up and go pee again, whatever. And Becky was sleeping and I put on my flats. I got up and I didn't fall. Like, I was totally good. I was fine. I think I took about 3 steps and I don't know why, but Twinkie had a few of her really small dog foods on the floor. And I think I just like slid on one, but instead of going backwards on my butt, my body just naturally went forward and I landed on my right knee. So the night before I landed on my left knee, and then the next night I landed on my right knee, but this time it was from a higher spot and I just went boom, like to the floor, like super loud. And Becky was sleeping and she was right there like as it happened, because I was getting up from the bed and she was sleeping in the bed, obviously. She got up so fast, you guys. I swear, if there's ever like an issue or an emergency, you need a Becky on your side. Because as soon as she noticed I was on the ground, like, she was up like this. I was just like, I couldn't even blink. And she was like by my side trying to help me up. The second time was farther away from my bed. And I can't really get up off the floor without using some sort of like a table to hold on to or like a chair. I can't just get up off the floor like without any sort of like help. And every time I go like on my knees, I can't go on my knees at all. The pain is excruciating, obviously. So when you're my size, you don't want to go on your knees. That's obvious. So I couldn't get up at all. I was really embarrassed this time, actually, because I almost was to the point where I was like, I don't know what I'm gonna do because I have no way of getting up. I wanted her to call the ambulance almost. I didn't feel any pain again. Like, there's been no pain. Like, when I fell, there was no pain. There's no pain now. I'm just very happy that I didn't hurt myself, because at my size, any sort of like fall can really hurt myself and land myself in the hospital, and it could be a very bad situation when it comes to healing. I don't need anyone like preaching at me about that, because trust me, I already know. I get it. What I ended up doing was I got on my side and I literally rolled onto the bed again, which was easy to do. It did kind of hurt. Obviously, you're on a hard floor and my body naturally isn't meant to be on a hardwood floor. It's not meant to be on the floor at all. At my size, I shouldn't be on the floor. I'm able to get up from my bed totally fine, but it's just the last 2 nights, I don't know, like, weird coincidence. But yeah, it was just really embarrassing that at 27 years old, if you fall, you should be able to get yourself back up. And I kind of just laid there in shock, and I told Becky to turn around. I was like, Becky, turn around. I don't want your help. Thank you. Like, she was trying to help me, and I was like, you're not gonna be able to help me, and I don't want to hurt you. Like, you know, I didn't want to put her in that situation. And it was just, I keep looking over there because that's where it happened, and I'm just like, oh. It was bad. I laid there just pitifully, and I was just like doomed. I felt doomed. I felt defeated. I felt weak, and it was just embarrassing. So this is in front of my girlfriend.
I didn't say anything during all of that because I just wanted you guys to soak in that story as it is. There is one other video I have to show. And then after that, I mentioned MSPEC, so I was going through the gallery she had sent me. But there's one other video I haven't played of Becky. Sorry, of Becky, not Vicky. There's no Vicky in the story. And after that, I'll talk to her a bit, because I do have some questions that I couldn't answer in my own research. Let's see. There it is.
Becky's getting pulled over.
Not scared. Becky's calm, cool, in control. Look, she's getting her license and registration out. She already knows.
Hi.
How you doing?
I'm doing all right. As soon as I looked down and saw I was going that fast, and I saw you turn around, I'm like, I'm pulled over.
I appreciate that.
I'm so sorry.
I got you at 78.
Yeah, I'm so sorry. I didn't even realize how fast I was going.
Have you got any insurance, all that good stuff on your car?
I do have insurance. I have my card.
Sometimes I can, sometimes I can't.
Okay.
I'll see what it shows.
All right.
On registrations, it really depends on your insurance company how often they report to the Department of Transportation on all that. Okay.
I don't think I have my old one in here right now.
Okay. That's not a problem. Have you got the registration on the car?
Am I good?
Yeah, you're good. Is it in the trunk, you said? Okay.
Be careful. I can't remember if there's actually anything funny in this video, but there is a funny comment I desperately want to show people. I have no idea how much longer this goes on. I imagine it's only like a minute or more.
He's actually really nice, so that's good. So hello everyone, right now we are in Walmart, and
that's the,
we need to do a little bit of grocery shopping, but we'll look around.
I specifically wanted to show you this video because this comment makes me choke laughing. I don't know if I can do it justice. The cop was probably low-key moved that a developmentally delayed 14-year-old boy without a neck is acting as a caretaker for a 600-pound manatee being strangled by a seatbelt. That is the best fucking YouTube comment I've ever seen. She does not moderate her video comments at all. I think because she knows she gets money from the people that watch her videos. Because, again, they're women, so they don't have ad block. And they frequently complain. Apparently, her videos have like 80 ads a minute on them. So it's just preposterous. All right, let me see if I can get her. M Specs, are you there? Can you hear me? I think she's... Yes, let me make sure... Oh, I'm glad I checked. I'm glad I checked to make sure the audio was working. I think we're good. Are you alive?
Yes.
Okay, I have a question.
Okay.
Tell me about Crystal and Destiny, because I did not find, I found relatively little on them compared to the other show. Are you alive?
Yes, you keep cutting out.
I keep cutting out? I think
it's probably me.
I think that's,
it's probably
yeah,
me.
It's probably you.
Okay, I can hear you now.
Crystal and Destiny, tell me about them.
Oh god, okay, so Crystal was Amber's girlfriend, air quotes, after Casey. She was her girlfriend when she started her YouTube channel. There is like discussion if they were really together or not, because Crystal is kind of like, there's something wrong with her. She has something developmentally going on. And she was basically paid by, Amber was basically paid by Crystal's parents to, like look after her, like, be a companion.
Yeah, it made me wonder if they were paying her to be, like, a girlfriend, like, actually paying her for that.
Well, yeah, that's what some people think. And Amber is, if people say this, Amber is like, you guys are crazy, you make up the stupidest shit. It's like, well, why are her parents paying you like thousands of dollars to do nothing then?
What was Crystal's problem?
No one knows for sure, but she's clearly delayed in some way. Like, she's not a complete, like, you know, she's not like completely mentally retarded, but there's something going on.
If you're in chat and you happen to have a video of Crystal, like, I've not seen anything of her.
If you go just way back to the beginning of Amber's channel, that's when you're going to find the videos that Crystal is in.
Okay. I'll try to do this.
There's nothing that's...
So, I mean, was she just slow? Like, did she just talk slow and shit?
Yeah. She's just kind of slow, but there's not like a lot of good videos from that time because Crystal wasn't in her videos as much as her later girlfriends were. there's some, like, when I think of Crystal, I think of these, like, gross Facebook screen caps where her and Amber are, like, flirting on Facebook, and it's gross.
She posts a lot of fucking videos. Holy shit.
Not as much as she used to. She's getting fucking lazy lately.
All she has to do is put a camera on her and talk about shit. How do you fuck
that
up?
That's really hard, Noel. That's really
no, it's
hard.
Not. What's hard is scouring like 8 years of shit to put together a stream to talk about it, okay? That takes a fucking long time to do.
It's really hard to remember to bring your camera when you're going out to remember to vlog, okay? I know this is hard because she's told me it's hard a million times. I forgot to vlog. That's her go-to excuse whenever she does, like, anything, actually, that might be semi-interesting to watch.
How many years ago was Crystal? Because right now I'm about 4 years in the past.
Yeah, Crystal was 2014. That's when she started her channel.
All right, let me see if I can...
But she's not really in a lot of videos. Mostly, like, it will be her filming for Amber while she does stuff.
Is she, so does she like have a shortcut,
hear,
like,
hear her,
oh, this has to be her. She has, like, the golden brown hair and looks kind of like Connor?
Well, golden brown? She has brown hair.
But it's really shortcut, right?
Back then I think it was longer. She has bangs. She kind of looks like Amber.
Okay, if I have to do this one more
time. Right, I think I found a video of...
Golden brown sounds like Destiny if it's short.
I'll take a screen cap of her. Where the fuck is she in this video? She's in the thumbnail and I can't find her in the actual video. This is deceitful advertising, lady. I want to see your retarded ex-girlfriend.
Oh, no, this does not look like an old enough video to be from Crystal.
It's from 4 years ago. I just want to see the tard girl. What does she look like?
So she wasn't with Crystal that long before she got, like, in terms of...
Wait, this is this her? She does look like Amberlynn. She has the bangs and she has, like...
Wait, okay, the glasses.
Yeah, the one that... Dusty Tomo, April 9th, 2014, Life with Amberlynn.
Yeah, that's okay. Her.
This is a quest now. God, it's just like she looks way thinner, and she looks way.
Okay, well, see, Crystal used to be like heavy, not as heavy as like Amber, but she used to be heavy, and they like were losing weight
together.
And then you know, well, we
so,
all know what happened with
this
Amber.
This is the view y'all
but
have
Crystal
to deal with right now
weight.
Because that's just how it works in my life.
Yeah, that's her.
Oh, my arm. So.
She's not said anything so far. She's just, like, sitting there staring. Say something, lady. Say something.
Oh, God, the snake bite piercings.
Why won't she talk?
Even Amberlynn's making fun of her for not talking.
Dinner time. And I don't feel like cooking.
Is that it? Is that the only appearance of her in the video?
Amber's being a bitch. She knows Crystal didn't like to be filmed for her vlog.
She's probably got the autism.
Are you making fun of me?
Yeah, exactly.
She's making fun of me.
She danced on camera for me, monkey. And Crystal's like, I don't know.
I have to hear this woman talk.
I'm gonna have to be a bitch and make fun of her on camera.
Good morning, everybody. Or evening.
Actually,
let
me check chat. Chat might have given me a link by now. Might be spamming it, screaming at me. Wait, okay, is this it? Blondie posted something. Blondie, you're my lifeline. You better be right. What is this? Girlfriend. Oh, this is her. Oh, this is way, way back because she's fatter. The girl is.
I wasn't ready.
Yep, that's
Hello,
Crystal.
Everybody. So, I'm gonna be, I don't know. I feel like I'm gonna be laughing a lot in this video. Because here is Crystal.
Yeah. That's her. We found her. We got him, everybody.
Okay,
yeah,
so
she's so awkward. She doesn't want to talk at all.
Okay, so as you all know, she's super shy. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to be here for her for this moment. So this is the girlfriend tag.
Oh, God.
And
how
don't
small
be looking. Don't be cheating. Don't be looking at the answers.
Which is,
so
like,
there's
wild
20
because
questions.
She was still over 300
Yeah,
pounds.
She has to be 300 pounds, but she's, like, 600
okay.
now.
So there's 20 questions.
I know.
And
but
they're, like,
about
me.
She looks like,
and
she still
we have
looks
to
like
see
a person.
If she gets them right.
Like she's yeah,
she looks fat, but she still looks. She has a human form to her.
No, but you know me.
She's still not said a word. I can't believe this. This is how do you think this is a good idea?
Face outside of the camera. You're like,
Yeah. Well, Amber. Amber's not that smart. Like she's cunning in a way, but she's not smart.
Okay. This is gonna be fun.
So weird.
So there's 20 questions. So we better get rolling.
Here.
Okay.
Why did they break up?
This is like. Well, because. I guess they both lost interest in each other.
Number one.
Like, she's towards the end, when they were still leaving each other, towards the end, like,
that means me.
Amber had already hooked up with Destiny. She had met her online and was, like, going to move to see Destiny. And I guess Crystal was also seeing someone else.
And I wrote my answers down.
But
so
their relationship is weird because Amber says like they're still best friends and all that.
Honesty here.
And
okay, so what am I watching?
All you have to do to make the Tard happy is watch Naruto with her. This is the easiest job in the world, lady.
No, that's Becky.
Alone.
Oh, this is so bad. She can't get her to say anything.
I'm watching Catfish Alone.
I know this.
I watched that with you.
What's your favorite show?
Oh yeah,
okay. Catfish is my favorite show. But
Amber Girls in Chat are right. Crystal did dump her.
Imagine getting dumped by this chick.
Meant, like if you didn't know me, I guess.
No, this is
if
now.
If Becky doesn't dump Amber, she's
you're
breaking
silly.
Like
okay.
a long streak.
Number two, you're out to eat. What kind of dressing does she get on her salad? So what salad would I order?
Caesar.
Correct. Caesar salad.
Kaiser salad. I still say that. If I go to a restaurant, I'll accidentally autism up and say Kaiser salad. Because of Fallout New Vegas.
Raw tomatoes.
Raw tomatoes? I'll show you guys. Yeah, they can't see that. I'm not lying.
I don't know, chat. Tomatoes. Let's do the gay one and two thing. Press one if you think she has a developmental disorder. Press two if she thinks she's just camera shy.
Oh, Aunt Tammy, were you talking about?
Oh,
Aunt
fuck!
Tammy?
No, I spoiled it.
No.
You reminded me. I did not bring up Aunt Tammy. I was gonna forget about that. Oh, everybody's saying Ave. Okay, I'm seeing ones. People think she's got the tism, which I do agree with. Actually, it's pretty split. People think she's just camera shy. I don't know. Would you want to be on camera with Amber Lynn, Ems?
No. I would maybe have a phone call with Amber Lynn just for the experience.
Oh, I can't wait to see her video about this. About the cyberbully game kicking. Because you know she's going to see it.
Oh, of course she's going to see it. I doubt she will say anything about it.
She said something about, she addresses it whenever, or addresses the forum whenever we say something about her. Like, she posted the fucking, hi, I'm Amber Lynn, and she posted the thing about PewDiePie showing up in that video.
Oh, no, she definitely reads everything. She used to, like, have fake accounts where she would go into, like, Facebook groups that were about her and be, like, commenting with people there. So,
Cindy,
yeah, she reads the forum every day.
Cindy says that she's here right now. She's among us.
No, probably.
One of the 1,200 people watching this. She probably takes up like 4 or 5 of those viewers.
She's gotten a little bit smarter that she will very rarely call people out by name unless she wants like that attention.
Actually, since you're here, I guess you paid attention to the Aunt Tammy thing really closely, right?
Most of that happened before I got into Amber, but, like, I know about it,
okay,
yeah.
So I mentioned very, very early into the stream, probably before most people watching or started watching, I mentioned that she was raised, or she was birthed by? I don't know how to describe this. Her birth parents are meth heads, and she went into into social services very early in life. And
yeah.
I think she had two brothers. One of her brothers got formally adopted, but she and her brother stayed in social custody for a while until I don't know if both of them or just her were put into foster care by her aunt Tammy, who some people say is crazy. I don't know enough to attest to the mental status of Tammy. but she is very remarkable to me. And
I can't remember if just one of her brothers got adopted. Like, Amber definitely did it, but... that doesn't really mean
adoptive parents are probably like, I can't fucking feed that. I can't afford that shit. Give me the brother. He looks like he runs. But no, Aunt Tammy is special.
Well, according to Amber, her brothers like beat the shit out of her when she
was.
Is
that where
younger,
she learned
so...
it from? From her brothers?
Oh, maybe.
Okay, again, the interesting thing about Tammy is that she joined the forum. She joined the forum as interventionist. I verified this for sure. This is Aunt Tammy. Yep. This is Amberlynn's adoptive, or not adoptive, but foster mother.
No, that's her real aunt.
For fucking, I guess for years, probably throughout her teenage years. And she's posted 100 times on the Kiwi Farms. And she still apparently reads it. She was last active less than a week ago. So she joins the site to talk shit about Amberlynn, and I guess to call her a liar, right?
Yeah, she called her out on a lot of shit.
Like, but like then, what? Give me something. What did she call her out on?
Just a lot of lies that Amber told about her childhood, basically. I mean, Amber lies about everything, so it's not that hard to call her out on shit.
Well, it's funny that the stream with Casey was basically that, too. I don't know if Casey had any internet presence before. Because you said they weren't streaming before she got with Crystal and started losing weight with Crystal, right? So Casey was before the live stream.
Yeah, Casey was her relationship before Crystal.
And Crystal's when she started streaming.
And then... Yes.
So Casey came before, but Amberlynn put out videos shitting all over Casey and calling her a rapist.
Oh yeah, she accused her of raping her.
And so Casey comes back. She streams on You Now for about 2 hours, where I played a lot of clips from that video, timestamps courtesy of Cunt. I think that's her YouTube username. It's just CXNT.
Yeah. And she's on Kiwi too.
Yeah, she's like 66 Eve or something. She's the girl that you heard laughing in a lot of those clips because of how she records it.
Yeah, CXNT is a saint who records all of Amber's You Now shit.
But yeah, she's on the forum too. She clipped that stuff. And in the same vein, I guess Tammy comes out and just says, "You're full of shit, lady." What's funny is on the Firefox, when I was searching for a video, if you type in any permutation of the name Amberlynn Reed, we are like the top two results. And, and her name, like anything else she does, is like the second result. And I'm sorry, I don't know. That's just funny to me. Except when, apparently, on Israeli Google, she's the first result for her name. So, he's cornered the Jewish market, Amberlynn.
I don't know, I've never used Israeli Google, so, wouldn't know.
So what about Destiny? Because a lot of people in chat were talking about Destiny being the best girl. Is that true?
She was, because that when she was with Destiny, her content wasn't complete trash.
Did Destiny help, or
when she was with Destiny? Well, Destiny was like a lot better than Becky in a lot of ways, because like she wasn't as dumb and awkward as Becky, but she wasn't as enabling as Becky either. Like, Destiny had her own shit going on. You know, she had a job. She wouldn't quit her job for Amber. Like, Amber wanted her to, like, leave her job because she's like, you know, I make enough money on YouTube. I can take care of you, baby.
Is it true that Amberlynn worked for the FBI or something during this time?
Oh, my God, no. She likes to throw out. I had a government job that she was barely at before she quit.
Well, she has a degree in criminology, right?
No, she doesn't. She did not graduate.
God, all these rumors being dispelled all at once.
No, she did not graduate. She went to school very briefly when she was with Casey. And no.
Did not graduate.
She did not graduate.
Well, did she make good grades?
She lied about her grades too. She was like, I worked really hard and got a 4.0. And then you go and dig back her old screen caps from that time and she's talking about like bombing shit. She lies about everything. Like, that's what you need to remember about Amber.
Well, it's usually she like small petty lies too. Liar.
Yeah, that's okay. So a lot of people wonder like why people like following Amber as a cow, because they're like, she's just fat, which like, yeah, but she's a death fat and she lies about everything and she's a troll.
A death fat? Is that what you said?
A death fat? Yeah.
That's so mean. See, this is why I said this early. Women are fucking like cruel when they get to like locales and shit. Their locales get nicknames like death fat. I don't think we called anybody else a death fat.
I didn't even come up with that. That's what they
call. Oh jeez. That's awful. I disavow these awful comments.
You don't really disavow, you're just saying that.
That's your opinion. I also love the nation of Israel. I'm just throwing it out there.
That's the truth.
So, I don't have any videos of Destiny either, unfortunately, because I focus mostly on
what?
Well, do you have?
Oh, good. You can just go to Amber's YouTube and just there's shit tons.
Okay,
of videos,
motherfucker, Destiny. Give me a name of a good video to find. What does Destiny look like? Is she the one with the copper hair?
She's the one. She has the short blonde hair. Okay. She kind of looks like a boy.
I went too far.
What's a good video of Destiny is the one where they like go out to eat and then Amber lies that the waitress like called Destiny an it.
Well, Destiny was the one that recorded the nature footage. Here is Amber Lynn in her natural habitat. What is the Denny's.
Okay. I need my girls to help me out. What is the video where Destiny was like doing the sexy? Like Amber was filming her in her underwear and she had like the cat and she was like a stripper. I need you guys' help because I don't remember the name of that video.
I'm gonna play the baby food challenge in the meantime. That sounds like it's quality. I wanna see Amberlynn eat baby food.
21st birthday shoot, is that it? That was
Oh yeah, didn't she do something when one of her girlfriends turned 18, or am I thinking of somebody else?
Well that wouldn't have been with Destiny.
Destiny looks, God, her girlfriends are so weird looking.
Destiny? Oh my God, the baby grind on me video.
Oh, is the baby food video worth watching?
Probably not.
Motherfucker, I need, let me check chat. Chat, help. Help me, chat. Somebody link it.
Okay, well, a lot of people have said the 21st birthday shoot. Video.
Okay, let me Google it.
Yeah, just search it.
I'm tapping on Sessa.
I'm sorry, I don't. It's hard to remember the names of all her fucking videos, okay?
They eat a baby. Sex on the Beach, Destiny's 21st birthday. Is that it?
Yeah. Or no, it's a photo shoot. There's several videos about her.
About her 21st birthday?
Thank you.
Destiny.
And she is having birthday cake for breakfast.
This is when they're eating birthday cake. Oh my God, she's naked. I saw it in the thumbnail. I'm skipping to this.
We just got back, and I'm sorry.
No, she's not naked. It's just that her hair is hiding her.
In the moment, plus it's at a strip club.
She went to a strip club.
Wrong to be filming them. Like that's probably against the.
She just said she broke the law. Oh God, this is incredibly awkward. She got the strip club to do a happy birthday song for her. They sound so unenthusiastic.
No, okay, no, it's the 21st birthday photo shoot.
You fuckers are spinning me around and around. Photo shoot. Sexy time? Care Bear Terry's 20? No, that's a different guy. Oh, I see it. I see it in chat. Thank you. Thank you. From C3P bro again and a couple other people. What's this one? Oh, it didn't have Destiny in the title at all, so I couldn't find it.
Literally, I just woke up. I'm talking like 5 minutes ago, so.
Why is there a little kid? You don't want little kids in your sexy photo shoot video.
Those,
are you going to eat your food?
Those kids are in Destiny's
You're
going to
eat your eggs?
They were in a lot of videos.
That kid looks so that kid looks unhappy to be filmed like her other girlfriend did.
Are you going potty?
Well,
you know, when I was a little girl, my mom Becky's told me the only time I ever
sister put her fucking
like
foot
that,
down when it came to filming her kids.
Because we had a red barn, and that's the only thing.
Amber had to delete a fucking video about it and then tried to lie about it.
Yeah, I don't want to put the kid up on the video. I feel bad as it is.
Do you have any blue balloons?
What?
Do you guys have any blue balloons?
Where's the sexy photo shoot? I don't want children in my sexy photo shoot video, Amber Lynn Reed.
What's that on your head?
There we go. Oh, God.
Wait. Back up.
You don't need no chaser.
Okay. She's drinking Fireball and Jaeger. And Maker's Mark. Oh, jeez. Ethan Ralph would fit in just fucking fine in this party.
I don't know about that.
Oh, gosh.
Real close and holding that wine glass up. I don't know.
That wine glass. This is hella southern now. Where's the sexy photo shoot at? I was promised underwear.
Just wait. She's... She's gonna be posing.
Like this? Yeah, she wants to see some of the alcohol.
Wait, she's posing with a double shot of Fireball? She looks like a 14-year-old boy.
She's 21.
Oh.
She's 21. She can legally drink that Fireball now.
Or the Fireball.
This is class. This is all class.
Or the Fireball shot.
This is fucking rednecky. Virgo, I can feel Virgo Rouge having a fucking stroke watching this. She's holding that cake. She looks tired. She looks physically exhausted from holding that cake up.
She probably is. Probably fucking hot.
Is this Chris Griffin?
That's mean.
That's pretty funky right there.
Oh, do some cutesy stuff.
Yeah.
I mean, at least the scenery is kind of pretty.
And somebody asked me, Down Forward Punch asked me in a super chat, if I to do a stream on John Bulla. Are we going to do like a Pensacola locale marathon? Just everybody from my home city?
She knows what she's doing.
Leave Ebola alone.
Oh, yeah, I can't do Ebola because people will be fucking mean to him. He's in jail right now.
Yeah.
No, she didn't. Wow. He wasn't a gross
kid? Watch the ones where they abuse their animals. Do you know that one?
If you just, like, search that on YouTube, cat we'll have scratches. Made, like, other people have. Yeah. I mean... I think the term like abuse.
You know you're gonna have to get in the picture.
Because I know the clips are. I do want to give her talking about. They're talking about a clip where they throw all right, look one of her animals like over her shoulder and well, Destiny like hits one of them. That's like the worst thing that happens in that video.
I can't get over how like how shapeless Destiny is.
But Amber is a really bad fur mama. She does not take care of her animals, especially Twinkie. From the front of it, I want you to like that dog is fat as fuck now. She's talking about having a lump.
Her name, well, the dog's name is Twinkie. It was doomed from the start. It's just it's fucked.
Store. That's the dog's full name. Twinkie Store. It's Star pronounced like
thing you.
Store.
Yeah, no. Slowly put it in your mouth.
Oh, jeez. This is so awkward. Especially when you consider that it's Destiny's mother doing the photographing. I
can't see, okay, now we're getting sexy.
I'm physically repulsed by this video.
Got something on your nose over there.
You can go down, that's a good one. There's something crawling on my head.
Now they're doing some photo shoots by the little fence.
Where are they at? Are they in Florida?
It's so cute.
No, they're in Kentucky here.
Like, right behind me, there were literally like 15 cows.
They're like in a rural fucking area.
And like every like I want to say like minute we turn around, there were these.
Good Mackie says, how depressing must your life be to spend most of your time making fun of other people? I'm not making fun of her. I'm cherishing the differences that we all have in our walks of life. Don't paint this wrong.
No, I'm making fun of her.
That's fucking M's. Okay, don't lay that on me.
Disavow me. Go ahead.
Is she just like eating the cake with her hands in this film? Where'd that go? No, fall back. Oh god, she's got cake all over her fucking hands. Like she just dug into it like a fucking animal.
Guess who the culprit was? How's it taste?
The cake is good.
Damn. I'm sweating. Literally. And I don't sweat. Like, it was really hot out. Like, I planned on just being here for, like, support and whatnot. God. But
again, Amber looks so much smaller. I was in a photo shoot,
too. Oh, like, God, they got cake all over themselves. Weird. That's so gross.
That became
That's like their default, though. Cake fight.
It's not as gross like, as, you know, with the fucking cake on her face, Destiny looks like Flexo from Futurama.
I mean, I haven't seen any of it. I didn't want to make up for the fact that I really didn't think I was going to be in it. But everyone's like, come on. I'm like, okay. So I guess we'll see what the photos look like. I'll definitely show them to you guys.
Okay.
You know what would be a good video to watch is the video where Amber buys Destiny like 100 Christmas presents.
So, the November one, right? Where they made them open them.
It was fun. I'm glad you were in it, too.
Yeah, they opened them early.
You made it.
And
yeah, to try and guilt Destiny to not dump her, right?
And then broke up with her. Yes. That was Amber's, like, last-ditch effort to buy Destiny.
Oh, Jesus. There's kissing. Ah! That made my prostate, like, ache. Like, somebody stabbed me in my... you don't understand. Don't judge.
I don't think I want to.
Imagine getting stabbed in your butthole. That's what it feels like. Chat's freaking out. Okay, let's find this fucking Christmas video. Any idea what it would be called? I'm looking chat. Tell me what I should look for.
You're gonna need to go further down.
Oh yeah, so I guess can I Christmas? No, that's last year. It's last year still. She made like 8 fucking videos about Christmas in just last year. Friends Christmas present swap. Is that it?
No.
From 1 year ago, does she still talk to Destiny? Because she's in the she's in the thumbnail. Oh.
No, that's not it.
Putting our Christmas. That's last year. Am I a hoarder? She has such clickbaity fucking video titles.
I know, it's because she's a troll and she wants those clicks.
Opening Christmas presents live 2 years ago.
Yeah, I think that's it.
Okay, it's 12 minutes.
It would be from 2016.
This is 2015, December 2015.
Oh. No, then that wouldn't.
You fucker, you lied to me. What I got for Christmas 2015. Christmas gift reveal 2 years ago, that can't be it.
So, I'm looking for the thumbnail from their breakup, because that video is like right after it.
Hey guys, happy Vlogmas.
God, why are the comments disabled on this? The comments and the ratings. This has to be it. This is December 10th, 2016. Chat. Oh, Blondie.
Wait,
to the rescue.
It's okay. Blondie's got it.
Fuck.
I'm like failing people, but I can't remember the exact
video title. No, we got all the best Amberlynn documentary safari people
in chat. I need them because...
Oh, you're on a phone or something, right? Hamburger reviews. Yeah, all these people, I've seen them. They're the people that like clip shit from Amberlynn's channel and re-upload it to Troller. And they're all watching this. That, yeah. That warms my heart.
Hey guys, so happy November 6th. We had the day off today. We ran some errands. We came home. I started to clean. And then
oh, the little kitten. Song, oh.
By Ed Sheeran.
Oh, we started dancing together.
Poor baby.
And then I was like, hey Destiny, you want to open one of your gifts? Just, I don't know.
Oh,
just,
did you talk about drama with Amber and these cats and Rafe?
No, somebody was mentioning about the animals, but this is the first kitty I've seen all stream.
Okay, well, just watch this, and then we can discuss another,
and then
this. Oh, yeah, fuck. Holy shit.
Are you guys ready for this?
Holy shit. It's like a mount. Oh, my God.
Like,
November?
Yep.
It's all clothes. Those are all clothes boxes.
You made the cats run. Did that hurt?
No, but...
Yeah, she's very careful crushing into that. Just kitties. I'm gonna fucking kill them. Flopping around like that.
There's a box right here that my little rice
pot's in. Baby, did you think it was gonna be a soft landing?
No.
Because it was like a loud noise. What the hell?
What the hell?
Okay, show them your, like... Some of your favorite.
There's nothing I can skip to. This is like content.
Because I know they're totally curious. Like, look at all this stuff. I got her some random, like, stupid things.
She's like sitting on the couch. She's not even like, oh, I fucking hate that.
Wave, like, poop bag.
It reminds me when I was a kid, I had really fat relatives who would just sit on the fucking couch and, like, and watch the shit unfold. Like, stand up. Stand up and get presents and do shit. Don't sit there, you fucker.
Things that, you know, that are, like, on the cheaper side, but, okay.
You can muster the calorie expense to stand up and get your present.
Okay, bye.
Look at this jacket. It's the coolest shit I've ever seen.
This is her. This is Amy trying to salvage.
Trainer!
Right here. I can't be less of a shithead.
You are number one.
Maybe if I just buy her a ton of shit.
Will it work for a couple months at least?
Please show them those Santa underwear. I can't with them.
Wait, what are people talking about with poop bags?
There's a black Santa.
She got her.
I thought that was
got cool. Her poop bags.
That's why I love it. Like,
oh,
diversity.
I thought they meant that she was actually shitting in a bag. I was excited for that. I was fucking hyped. I was like, show me the poop bags, please.
That would be quality.
This cup. She got it at the actual Disney store.
But the thing is, with Destiny, I never saw this. Before Destiny actually ended it, she was cheating on her with Dana.
What?
Yeah.
Oh, Destiny was cheating. I'm like, what the fuck?
Yeah, Destiny
was. You'll finish
was.
In a minute. I just want to show them some of the favorites Damn. That I got her that are like over here.
Look at that fucking hand. That's a fluffy hand.
I got her this Pixels 3D, which I thought was pretty cool. This is a Smithsonian, like... How would you explain that?
It's a projector. It projects the planets onto the ceiling.
Yeah, that was pretty expensive, like, but it was worth it. She really likes planets. And I got her some, like, cool shoes. I got her a few pairs of shoes.
God, so much trash.
This is a
when terrorists train radicals to bomb the United States, they show them videos like this. And, like,
yeah,
look,
and then it
look
plays,
at the endless success
like,
the Americans enjoy. They do not know what suffering is.
I don't know. Just so much stuff.
That hand was 200 pounds ago? Ugh, fuck that. Wait, this is only like a year ago. She gained 200 pounds in a year? No, it's 2 years. But jeez. That's still 100 pounds a year. That's fucking impressive.
200 pounds is a little...
Yes, it was.
Exaggerated, but basically...
He likes how he sounds. Let me look at this little thing. He's controlled by the app.
All right.
Send him on different missions.
I think we got the gist of it for this. Blondie sent another video, and she's been good so far. Let's see. Cat at 9 minutes onwards. That sounds like a plan.
Did you watch the breakup video?
Yes, I did. Is there something about it? Oh, is that the one where she's dancing and is drunk? I played the... I showed screen caps of it. I didn't play that video. Oh, I just showed her when she was drunk on Valentine's Day. Is there another one?
Yeah.
Really?
I think so.
Wow.
That's not
I really
the
like
breakup video.
Zelda
Switch. A mother and son Christmas.
Sad.
Hamburger is brutal.
And if we don't...
I'm hoping she's in like a good place.
Holy shit, that is not a flattering angle of destiny. Past,
you find them in
all Amber has done this to Amber is shit to all her girlfriends. That's what you need to know.
Well, look it, we got our
Amber
new couch.
Because
we
Amber's whole focus in the hard couch. Look better.
It's red.
Well, I know that in the current situation with Becky, the two gay guys she lives with run their own streaming thing, and they post videos where you can hear Amberlynn screaming in the background, and you get all these candid shots of her looking fat as shit.
That's not both of them. That's Eric. Ricky is his husband, and Ricky isn't as involved in all this shit. Ricky, because Ricky's the only one.
Wait, they lost the fucking cat?
There's our couch, by the way. It is so cute!
What? They lost the cat? Oh, no! When was this? Oh, this is last year. So I guess... Oh, kitty. Maybe it wanted to get away. Stop filming your fucking kids. You're gonna get me fucking banned from YouTube, you fucking fat ass.
And we have 9 others to do. More bad news, everybody.
For a date.
Places
right. For a date.
I guess that's all. That's all that was important in that is that Amberlynn lost the fucking cat. She crushed it. Don't say that.
Don't say that.
The cat got adopted by one of those crazy old ladies that hoard animals, and now he's just fat and fucking happy. That's what happened. That's what happened. Don't twist my emotions like that. Alright. I think that might be it. Unless you can think of anything. You said the breakup video. Well,
yes, the breakup video.
Okay, let me try to find that. Is that still on her channel? I noticed she doesn't tend to take videos down. She seems to be quite happy.
Actually, she's taken like the one video that she took down and caused her a lot of problems is the rape live video. But she doesn't actually have a big tendency to delete shit. Like, especially now. Now she, like, understands the YouTube game more, and she just doesn't give a shit. Like, that's why she doesn't disable her comments or ratings anymore.
Yeah, I think this is it. This is, We Broke Up.
It's just called We Broke Up.
Hey, guys. Yeah. So, I have actually already filmed this video. It was... Over
she does not.
There it is. Yep.
Okay, let me pause because we've seen several years of Amberlynn videos at this point.
Iconic look right here.
Well, that's the thing I was going to mention. Iconic. Like when you think of like a 40-year-old like Alabama woman who weighs as much as Amberlynn, and she usually has like the discoloration in her face, and she's cooking shit with like butter, and everything's fried, and she just looks like a hot mess, like. Amberlynn,
Paula Deen realness right here.
Yeah, you're like we're getting there. We're like halfway to that stereotype of a southern cooking wife.
Just
by the way, this is one of like the few shirts from that time.
I feel like it was me making a fool out of myself.
Looks like a fucking bathtub.
I did nothing but cry.
It does. So red right
now.
At least she's got it the right way around this time.
A 2-hour break after that video. Oh, yeah.
Well, because it did.
I said to myself, I wouldn't feel right
regular people go in neckline.
I don't want to come on here and cry the whole video. I owe it to my audience.
She looks actually distressed for once instead of like fake crying.
Anyone who has.
Because like when she did that poem for Casey, she was like fake crying throughout the poem. This looks like genuine emotional distress.
Oh yeah, she was fucked up. She's still fucked up over this breakup. She's still in love with Destiny.
Well, she got cheated on.
I have been on YouTube for quite some time, as you guys know.
Destiny is like her soulmate.
My fair share of moments.
She fucking loves Destiny.
And you guys
to be honest, if somebody cheats on you and you stay friends with them afterwards, you're a cuck. I don't know what the female equivalent of a cuck is, but that's pretty fucked up. You can't do that.
Destiny saved
you gotta cut them out.
Dark place. Like.
Wow, she's like legit crying.
She is.
Yeah.
I'm like,
because at this point, they had been broken up, and she had been hiding it for, trying to hide it for a little bit. in a few videos.
She's one of the most amazing people. But then,
like, Destiny on Facebook, like,
you don't have
she
to
didn't
be
list herself as, like, in a relationship with Amber anymore. And so people were like, what's going on? She was like, fuck, I have to go
a family member.
Yeah, she tends to do that. She tends to hide it until she can.
I am literally a mess. But this is...
And oh my god, she's so fucking creepy in this video, too.
Just,
she talks about, like, making Destiny still sleep in the same bed with her.
Ooh, what?
Yeah, just wait. Like,
why is Destiny's...
Are we going to watch all of this then? It's like 12 minutes, but that sounds good.
Why is Destiny...
That sounds like some good tea.
Facebook said that she's single. Why aren't you on her profile picture? Like, what is happening? Like, why are you doing this to us? And I really didn't feel like I was doing anything to you guys. There is just some parts of life that takes you on such a fucking roller coaster that when you're so down and you're so low.
I'm sorry, I'm like literally laughing at her.
You don't talk about those moments. And sometimes you need to heal from those moments. But on January 13th, ironically enough, it was actually Friday the 13th. Destiny broke up with me. Since then, I have filmed videos. I've put on fake smiles. I have cried every single time I shut off the camera. I have screamed in my pillows. I have questioned if I am worth
anything. You're so mean. You're like that other girl, that the CXNT person.
I need to watch this video before, so like I know what she's gonna say. Like I screamed in my lowest.
Like I'm the big mean cyberbully that runs a fucking cyberbully emporium, and you're just some chick, and she's like talking about how she's having a mental breakdown and shit over a breakup where she got cheated on, and you're just like giggling in the background. It's like what the fuck. Fucking women.
She still thought I was the most beautiful thing.
Good
she's ever
shit.
Seen. I look like a crazy.
This
right
is
now.
What karma looks like, but, right here.
Is this Crystal's revenge?
Why she broke up with me, or what
revenge.
Happened? That whole thing is very, like, up to Destiny. But she broke up with me, and it is so fucking, like, the most craziest concepts of the world is the fact that you as a person can have your whole future planned out, your whole, just everything so planned out, and you think you have everything going for you, and someone can just kind of rip that away from you and completely take that from you. And
see, if you don't think this is funny, she's like
I
filming
feel like
this.
That's what Destiny did.
Like Destiny's
we had
in like the
so
other room just feeling
planned.
Some shit.
Well, somebody said that
I'm so in love with
one woman in the chat and said something like, "We know how this feels that. As women, but we also know that she's a like, bitch, so that makes it funny."
Exactly.
And somebody else said, let me try to find it because it was a good comment. I don't want to talk over the video for all this time. Where the fuck is it? I'm going to be so mad if I lost this. Fuck. I saw it. It's gone. No. Oh, well. I'll think of it eventually.
Never give up on her. I will try everything in my power to fix whatever is going on with her, and
if you join the stream late, this is her breaking up with her main girlfriend,
like,
I guess.
Some of you knew that we broke up. And a lot of you were
saying
that I was doing this for
It was kids. Based off what you said, that it becomes fair game once you live stream it and post it on the internet. Like, I guess this would be mean in person, but, like, the moment you put it, like, on the internet for clicks and shit, I have Adblock on. Does she monetize, like, even this video?
Oh, hell yeah. She monetizes.
Well, if there's a
video of herself, like, crying about, like, attention. I'm so afraid, like, attention. Because,
no, you know,
shit is
not.
Getting real now, and then there's seven this ads is one on of it.
That's funny. Okay, if there's a price to entry, I get to do whatever Destiny the fuck I want with it. You have no control over
that. Chicken money.
The most incredible person in the world. And one of the best things that has ever happened to me was being hers. It was being her girlfriend. And you know, I don't really know what to say. So when you were like, well, how come she's still in the vlog? Like, why does it say single if she's still in the vlog? We do still live together. We don't want to lose each other in the sense of, like, being friends and stuff. And we're even still sharing
the same bed.
I know a lot of you are going to be like, what? It's very much an attachment thing.
God.
I feel like
that's creepy.
Honestly not going to be able to sleep alone.
Yeah.
I just feel my anxiety and my
I wouldn't be able to sleep alone. So it has to be her idea.
The absolute roof. But her breaking up with me has done damage to my heart. It's completely broken.
Like, and see, this is like the thing. She's so manipulative.
This video. I was hiding it from you.
I mean,
guys.
Do you think she's being manipulative, like, even in this? So or
to act like everything was okay, and to act like, you know, I would ignore the question and I would bypass everything that was mentioned about Destiny, and because I was embarrassed, I'm hurt, I just feel like I wish I can turn back time and just fix everything. And a lot of you are like, does this have something to do with the job video? It has nothing to do with the job video. Like, everything I said in the job video is 100% truthful. And my boss has actually seen that video. She loves my YouTube videos. But yeah, everything I said in that video is 100% correct. Some of you guys were like, she said single because she said she's single because something about the job, and I don't really know what you guys are talking about, but no, that's not it at all. Has something to do with that. It's more so like something going on internal with Destiny, and it's just not, it's not up to me to share that with anybody. That's not
It's called something internal. Destiny's over here being a fat bitch to her.
You know, that's not right, I guess. And
I just can't imagine ever wanting anything to do with anybody who ever cheated on me, ever.
I'm still gonna make YouTube videos.
Yeah, neither do I.
With a YouTube video tomorrow.
She's in love with Destiny.
Fucking smile, and it's probably gonna be
That's legit fucking weird that they still talk and shit.
Like, it's crazy. Like, Destiny really was like the perfect girlfriend for her.
No, like, YouTube,
and she completely fucked it up by being a bitch.
I have to make videos for you guys, and I have to.
How is she a bitch to Destiny?
And I just feel good to finally get
she was rude to her
chest.
All the time. She constantly put her down, smile. Like, on camera.
I can just be...
She wanted her to quit her job, basically, to...
Yeah, that's a bit fucked up.
...around her 24/7. Because, like, okay, here's the thing you have to remember about Amberlynn. Amberlynn is, like, a big fat toddler.
Have to work through.
Like, she's helpless on her own.
To work,
like, she doesn't, like,
yeah, she needs Becky's help to do anything now.
Well, that too, but
Destiny
has never
in my life she's
had a driver's license. She doesn't drive, she can't go places by herself. She needs her girlfriend or someone else there to drive her around.
The breakup was all up to her, and I can't force
so, like, now Becky fell into the trap that Destiny avoided.
I don't really
Becky,
know.
Becky like
to
made
say.
That deal with the devil, and now she's stuck being
I don't
Amber's
want
like chauffeur.
Well, what she just said is kind of telling because she said something. It was all up to destiny to make that decision. So she seems kind of embittered that she didn't.
And I know
she didn't get to fuck her.
Because trust me, I have watched YouTube
probably.
Before,
yeah.
They
well,
break up and like my heart is just shattered.
I mean, she got on Becky train right after this, so she found her next victim.
Becky's my favorite.
Why?
She's so harmless.
No, she's not.
How is she harmful?
She's harmful in the sense that she's boring as fuck, but...
Just know...
Becky is just... Like, I used to feel kind of bad for Becky, but... Becky is a straight-up enabler.
I'm still trying my hardest to film
of course.
For you guys. And to film for myself. Because
like, Becky knows what she's doing.
Distraction.
I mean, Amberlynn couldn't eat herself into a fucking scooter without help. She needs somebody to bring home food and shit.
It really fucking sucks.
No, exactly. Like,
and just to
and
think
I, like,
of the first
because,
time
like,
me and Destiny.
When you have,
it.
Like, this fat
and
bitch, like, screaming at you that, like, you know, she wants McDonald's at, like, 2
like
in the morning.
Before. And she said
that,
she never did either.
That that probably fucking sucks. But,
oh, fuck.
Like,
I have to pull something up. Keep going.
She still loves me.
She can throw Amber out of that
we
damn house, but
so
she doesn't
much.
Because
and
she has made Amber sole source of money.
Be
you know, Becky doesn't have a job.
That's how it was supposed to be.
She quit her job to
not.
Be
really
Amber's
know,
caretaker.
As of now, we are.
I'm gonna
together.
Have to. I'm gonna have. If I can find this, I would fucking. I would love to show people. You reminded me of something.
I don't have any juicy details. I don't have any of that. I don't know. I don't really know what to
I think this is the best I'm gonna get. Because I can't find the other one. This is a really low resolution picture.
Breakups are hard. Yeah. Bye.
Okay, that video's over. the person on your screen right now, if you're watching, is Casey, who is from the Christian Weston Chandler early trolling days. Casey was one of the girlfriends. Casey was most notable for being in the dad call, where Chris got chewed out. And Casey was like, you know, I'm a doctor, I'm a physician or whatever the fuck. I know health and you're not healthy. You need to be healthy. If you want to be my boyfriend, you have to be healthy. There's another picture of Casey where she is like morbidly obese, just really fucking fat. And the legend goes, I don't know if it's true or not, but the legend goes that she would wake up Liquid Chris, who was the boyfriend, and eventually they did get married in real life during this age. But she would wake him up and tell him to go get McFlurries, like in the middle of the night. And he would have to leave the fucking house and acquire McFlurries to feed the ham beast at any odd hour. It's not like she was pregnant or anything. It's just that she required McFlurries. And your story about thinking about Destiny or Becky feeding Amberlynn into her grave to death fat status. Reminded me of the McFlurries. And for people who missed it, because people did miss it, let me pull up another video that's not Amberlynn, but which is interesting. Because because people were talking about her shilling for BetterHelp.
Oh, God.
And she did. And I mentioned this earlier, so if you want
well,
the full story
actually,
with that.
Here's the thing.
Uh-huh.
Amber is such a fucking cuck. She shilled for them and she didn't even get paid.
She just did it because she saw other people doing it?
No. Okay. People like to shit on the Amberlynn forum, but they were on that BetterHelp shit way before anybody else because of Amber's fucking lies. Amber, she's just so lazy. Like, she won't go see a real therapist or a real doctor or anything like that. But people have been bothering her and do it for so long. She was like, well, I'll just use a
special
app
news segment.
You know,
special news segment.
She lied about being diagnosed by them.
Yeah, yeah. Well, let me play this clip from PewDiePie because it sums
I'm
it up.
Poppy Harlow, here for
no,
your
it doesn't because he doesn't know.
Any YouTuber mentioned.
This is the thing. Him and that fucking idiot Andy Worski.
Well, Andy, yeah.
Like, all these people. They took Amber at her word that this is what happened and like incorporated it into the
well,
rest of this.
I said that she told a lie that was so big it hurt the reputation of a $100 million therapy company and got PewDiePie to shit on them. Like, she's featured in this fucking video, and she's taking at her face.
I know. Thank God he blurred her face out.
Well, I made fun of that, too. Hold on, I do want to show people who missed this, because it's funny.
Provide a good service, because they don't take accountability for any of their counselors, which then leads to a lot of people having bad experiences. They say themselves that they don't diagnose. The platform is not intended for diagnosis. But then you have really questionable videos of YouTubers saying,
I suffer with binge eating, which I do want to talk to you guys about because I was officially diagnosed with binge eating disorder.
I wonder who that could be, guys.
I was officially diagnosed by their therapist. Okay, who diagnosed you?
If you guys have ever heard of BetterHelp.com,
oh, really? So you were officially diagnosed by a therapist? Therapists should not diagnose you, by the way. And BetterHelp themselves say that, but still, apparently, it happens.
I never actually received any therapy.
Okay, that's just the funny part. Somebody mentioned that this literally got posted like 3 hours ago, right before the stream started. We have to watch this. At least some.
Okay, so we're.
She's wearing her fucking shirt backwards still.
Actually have.
Oh my god, girl! Burger King! And she knows it's backwards now because, like, enough people were fucking telling her.
She just wants to show off the titties.
Doubling down.
But it's so funny. Like,
unless she filmed that.
I'm gonna title it that.
Like, she might have filmed that same day she filmed the haul.
That's what I
always. So I shouldn't say that for sure.
From Burger King. Was the exact okay. Thing, the spicy.
Okay, I can't actually, believe this. Right before our stream, she did a Burger King mukbang, or mukbang, whatever the fuck it is.
Of course she did.
I want to see her eat a cheeseburger.
Oh, that's so good.
I don't.
Okay. You are weak.
So,
eat that cheeseburger, motherfucker.
But I'm also going to be reading comments.
Eating has gotten so fucking gross lately. Yeah, like, she's taking way too many pages
cheesy
out of
the tots? You couldn't just get regular tater tots without fucking cheese in them?
Until she's eating.
Yeah. Comes with 8 little buggers right there.
She's like a shitty version of food review bra.
It's okay. And then we have a spicy sandwich.
I'll eat that sandwich.
Okay. Oh my god.
Is Josh turning into a feeder fetishist?
Oh god. No, but that's what this fucking video is for.
Okay.
Do you think there are people who legit pay for her because they like to see her eat?
Yes. She's talked before that she gets emails like from feeders.
So.
I mean, she didn't say that explicitly, but she'll be like, you know, I get messages from people being like, you know, when are you going to be on camera again?
Wait, this is the good part. This is the good part. Put it in. Put in ah. Why is it so funny? See, now you're disgusted, and I'm laughing so hard I have a headache.
Which I know is going to be harsh. But.
This just got posted. It's literally a couple hours old right now. That's fucking fantastic.
So, the last video I uploaded was the spaghetti mukbang. That just went up today, a few hours ago.
Oh, so, she took out, I didn't even notice that, she took out the fucking tomato. The one goddamn thing of sustenance. She rips it out, like, begone.
I'm not even gonna judge her for that because I fucking hate raw tomatoes.
You need the tomatoes on the chicken sandwich.
She got that lettuce. She got that lettuce. That's all she needs.
I'm a dietitian, y'all.
She just made a joke, I'm a dietitian. She knows. She knows how fucking awful this is.
He's scrolling.
Yeah. As I eat this. So.
I mean, she's trolling, but also, like, she's delusional, and she, in her mind, she does think that she's, like, knows as much as.
The fucking backstraps are, like, choked around her neck, because they're supposed to be at the base of her spine, or the back of her head. But instead, they're wrapped around her fucking neck.
Because she's not a smart person.
Because she's.
What are you doing?
Because she's wearing her dress on backwards. How do you not feel that?
I'm so dumb. Sometimes I'll repeat myself. Or, like, someone will say something to me, and then I'll repeat what they said. Like, why do I do that? So, Yeah, I have a dietitian now, and
she has a dietitian. That's bullshit.
More in a video, more of like plot points.
Yeah, I'll believe it when I see it. She told me. My God, okay, when she says this, actually,
I know a lot
she's
of
a dietitian.
Like,
she had some random who said they were a dietitian, like,
when I saw the doctor, like, reach out I was, like,
and offered to help her. So that's
like
probably what she's talking about.
I don't even know.
She does not have a fucking dietitian. She doesn't go see her doctor. Well, she doesn't have a real... Like, I will believe it when I see. I will believe it when I see.
Next comment is from someone named Amber Lard.
Amber Lard.
And her dietitian, this is her dietitian.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Wait, hold up, I have to rewind it. She read a comment from somebody named Amber Lard. Well, she's like reading troll comments.
It's from someone named Amber Lard. Hello. They said, won't believe because she probably made it up. I have no idea what you're talking about. I don't even remember what I talked about in the video that I uploaded today. So.
Why would you even read that?
No idea. This one's kind of long. Queen of the 99.
She has to keep the cycle going. Why?
I am a nurse.
She trolls, she lies, people call her out on her lies, she doubles down on the
ICU.
And then she like reads a troll comment to show she's not afraid of the trolls, but the comment she reads is out of context and she doesn't address it in any way.
That won't heal due to DM2.
And when she reads comments, she doesn't read
these patients were in their early 40s and younger. 30 is around the corner, and I really hope it.
And then like she'll do this bit, and then like the next day she'll lie and say she doesn't read.
If Amber Lard is in the chat, say something. Represent Amber Lard.
But yeah, her this dietitian has told her apparently that this is her new thing. That, you know, she gets all this fucking gross shit, but if she just cuts her meals in half and eats the rest like an hour later, it's all gonna be good, it, you know, and eat it on a blue plate. Like, that's the secret to weight loss.
You know, I wonder what a Korean person who watches mukbangs would think of this video. I wanna see, like, if can we take this video and restream it into the mukbang area of Twitch to see what, like, with a Korean title to see what Korean people say.
They would be talking.
I meant to say melatonin.
Me, that's for sure.
It's the diabetes.
It's the diabetes. No, diabetes.
Whatever.
It's making jokes about diabetes.
What was it?
That has to be like a coping mechanism.
I've actually been walking more.
Well, because she won't treat her fucking diabetes.
So.
Oh God, can you?
She lied the other day and said
a lot better.
Last time I got labs. Pre-diabetic, like, bitch.
Never happened.
No,
she could be pre-diabetic. She's young. She's like a little bit older than me. She's still young.
No. She is diabetic.
Can you imagine? I want to see the videos where she's like doing the pricking on her fingers and shit. It's good. She opened her fucking mouth to put in a cheesy tot, and she still had hamburger in her fucking mouth, bitch.
She doesn't take care of it. Like, she's in complete fucking denial about it.
Not quite, honey. You need to eat to survive. If I totally completely stopped eating, yeah, I'd lose weight.
But she has like diabetic like wounds.
2 weeks, but then I die.
She will have. She has marks like on her neck. You can't see it because she's wearing that fucking dress backwards. But like she has one mark on her neck that has been there for ages now.
Well, what, her skin's not healing like the fucking the anorexics.
I think I'm done.
When you have diabetes, it weakens your immune. So your shit's not healing right. It takes forever, and her knuckles are dark as fuck.
If I got someone just telling me,
like,
oh, I don't like your earrings, that, like, broke my heart. Like, I was like,
yeah. She's a fucking wreck.
Now I just don't care about anything.
I want to see, after this, I think I'm going to call it quits with this video. Because this is a great video to send off on. So if you're in chat, you need to tell me if you want a chinky song or a cheeky breaky song. Them's the rules. I'll type it so you understand.
I started YouTube 5 years ago today, by the way.
But, like, I didn't know that, right?
It's my anniversary. Oh, yeah, I cared. What? I'm 27, so I started YouTube when I was 22. Oh, yeah, I cared. I was so sensitive back then. Like, YouTube has built my skin to be so tough.
YouTube has built her skin to be so tough, but apparently her skin doesn't actually heal.
Something that I've just always known, and I've always felt, especially
they look out for each other too, and their family, like, they do it for the purpose of, like, living. We kill just
wrong. Somebody else is talking for her now, so she gets to eat faster. That's funny. That's really funny. I can't get over how big her channel is. She posted this video 3 hours ago, and she's gotten almost 20,000 views. That's crazy to me. Is it like all people hate watching or what?
Pretty much. Pretty much.
Look at it. Look at that. Oh, this is a fucking... I should make a... I'm totally making a hamburger. I said hamburger. I need to make an Amberlynn Reed enjoys hamburger after this. This is quality. I'm enjoying this video.
Sorry if you guys can't hear him, which I'm sure you probably can.
Oh, God. Like look at her fucking chin.
Does she have shit on it?
Whatever.
No, it's just really fat.
No, just look at it.
It's bulbous. It's like a Peter Griffin chin, almost, the way that it sticks out. It's just not a butt chin.
Like perfectly round now because of that. You can't even barely see her ears anymore. God, the fucking scrunchies. That's her new thing now. She's into scrunchies.
That's gay.
Anywho, so today...
She needs to bring back the bows.
She needs to bring back the cat ears.
She still does the cat ears sometimes. I'm just...
They're gonna see Griddle House?
Griddle House?
What is it?
Is this almost over? Oh, it's almost over. We got three more minutes left, guys.
So obviously I'm not
going to
go
and see. Oh, somebody...
3 more minutes of quality content.
Quality content. She's almost done. To her credit, she's packing it in for us. She's doing her best. CJF asks, can you discuss the bra she's been wearing every day for 5 years? What's the story with that?
Oh, my God. This poor bra. I don't know how this bra hasn't just, like, fucking, like, crumbled into her fucking hands by now. It's disgusting.
What's the story with it? Does she talk about it?
So high up on her fucking back. Does she talk about it? No.
Her chicken sandwich fell apart. Oh, that's funny.
So
now she has mustard on her lips. This is a sight. This is fucking entertaining.
I think what holds the calories is definitely, like, because it's breaded.
Oh my God! What the fuck? That's so gross! She just, like, shoves that shit. I can't believe that. She's on camera! You're on camera!
Ugh.
And then she's making that savory face. Like, she's doing this. She knew I would be streaming because the message went up. So she put up the most disgusting fucking thing she could, knowing I would watch it. This was a direct assault on me.
The most disgusting shit she could put up.
This, like, was an attack.
Let's be real.
A bite of that and a bite of that together. So good.
Alright, I see a message about a bra, but, like, really, I have to calm myself. I have to go get something to eat.
You
know me? Go get something to eat.
Like, go get a hamburger.
Like, I'm content, which...
Alright.
I should stay content, but...
You know what, I asked what kind of song you guys wanted. I'm gonna have... I have to put in an executive override and get executive override to get something else.
Whenever I eat at McDonald's, like, I get full rather quickly. I think this video is a mess.
She said that, like, it's a bad thing. She said she eats at Burger King because when she goes to McDonald's, she gets fuller faster. And she doesn't want that. She wants to engorge as much physical mass as humanly fucking possible. McDonald's well, potentially having a more filling meal is a detriment to her.
She doesn't actually like food. Yeah. She just likes the sensation of like eating and feeling full.
I'm so happy. I finally have one. So now people can stop saying that.
Oh my god, look at her fucking arm.
That's the only reason why. But
what did she say? She was so happy for what?
I really needed someone to tell me what to do.
Oh, a therapist or a dietitian. She's talking about her fucking dietitian again. You're so that's making me angry. You clearly do not have a dietitian if you're eating Burger King.
Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed this mukbang. I kind of feel like I look like a grandma today.
Because you're wearing your shirt backwards.
Anyways.
Ew, God. What, stop with these fucking chest shots.
Doesn't this look like a grandma's
shirt? She's so proud of her titties, but her titties are fat.
Well, here's the thing, though, that she, like, only, like, gaining more weight in her titties. Like, oh my, girl! How do you not know that's on backwards?
Okay. I think that's all we can do, because I'm definitely, I hope you guys, if you were planning on sending super chats, I hope you got it in, because we're fucked after this. we're gone. Thanks for playing. Is there any closing thoughts you have? Any final statements?
There is so much more I could say about Amber. Basically, in the words of many a commenter that I've now crushed from posting this on the site, fat! That's all I gotta say, I'm out.
You cut out a little bit. Yeah, she's fat. She's fat as fuck.
Fat!
I didn't get to show as many ankle pictures as I would have liked, but I'm gonna go ahead and put a song on, and I was emptying out that folder of images you sent me, so I'll continue to do that. I'll continue to throw images up as the song plays, and that'll be our outro. Okay, good. So thank you very much for joining me and helping illuminate some of the dark corners I didn't get to touch on.
Just dark corners. That's phrasing.
Oh, geez, not like that. Girl, I ain't touching them dark crevices. I ain't into that. All right, take it easy.
All right, you do.
It's just me now. It's just me and you. Thank you guys for watching. We got like over 1,200 people watching, and I'm very happy I got to share Amberlynn. I didn't know if this would do well or not. Lots of people who follow Amberlynn came in full time to watch somebody not so much in the know discover her in real time. So with that, let me play my song. You're free to go if you don't want to see the image montage I have. Thanks for watching. Where'd that fucking song go? Where the fuck did it go? There it is.
Yo, homeboy. Where you been, man? We been looking for you.
Yeah, we ain't seen you around Burger World lately. So where you been, huh?
Oh, you know, around.
Want a piece of pizza? Think I got an extra piece around here somewhere.
No, that's okay, thanks.
Yo, ding dong, man. Ding dong. Ding dong, yo.
No, thanks, really.
Yo, eat this, man. It's good for you.
I'm not really very hungry right now.
Hey, man, what it is with you? You on some kind of diet? Is that what they teach you in that little sissy school of yours?
Back off me, man. Back off.
The question is, are you fat or what?
Leave me alone.
I said, are you fat?
Get off me, man! Stop it!
You ain't down with us no more. You ain't fat. You ain't fat.
You ain't fat. You ain't nothing. You ain't nothing!
Is wide, well mine is too. Just watch your
sit on you. The word is out, better treat me right. Cause I'm the king of cellulite. Ham on, ham on, ham on whole wheat. Alright. My zippers bust, my buckles break. I'm too much man for you to take. The pavement cracks when I fall down. I've got more chins in Chinatown. But I never used a phone booth, but I never seen my toes. When I'm going to the movies, I take up seven rows because I'm fat, fat, I'm fat. Give me plenty space.